Menominee Maroon Sports Broadcasts are brought to you by North Honda Motorsports, Esser Glass, Bayshore Credit Union, Riverside Auto, State Farm Insurance, Tony Furton Agent, Prestige Auto Body, Colonel K's Pasties, Farmers and Merchants Bank and Trust, State Farm Insurance, Brent Narrett Agent, Dexter's, Menominee County Federal Credit Union, Menards, Advanced Motors, Peshtigo National Bank, Menza and Zach Heating and Cooling, Kane Chevrolet Buick GMC, and Bayside Motorsports.
And thank you, Jim. Good evening from Schofield Field at Anago High School. I am Josh Kellner, along by your side here again. Looking forward to a fantastic matchup. The Menominee Maroons take down the Red Robins from Antigo. Should be a lot of fun tonight. Both teams coming into this contest undefeated, even though Menominee only has one game underneath them belt, as they defeated Marinette last Saturday, 49-21, with the Antigo Red Robins have a couple games behind them, as they took care of Two Rivers in their opener on August 21st, 40-12. Last week in O'Connell, they took care of the Blue Devils, 35-0. So looking forward to a good one here today, talking to a lot of people here in the stadium, and they think this is going to be a good test for actually both teams, as the Antigo Red Robins have a lot to look forward to. This season, they have a new coach underway. He's like a third-generation coach, and they have a lot of people on their back and looking forward to some positive things, and they have a fine young ball club at that as well, as a rare junior varsity game took place before this one, and the Red Robins took care of the Menominee Maroons very easily. 48-18 was the final score in the junior varsity matchup, so the Menominee Maroon JV team still looking for their first win of the season, as they are 0-2 to start off the 2015 and 2016, school year, but 2015 football season. So that's the way the junior varsity game wrapped up a little bit beforehand as I got here, and it was just the final whistle blew, and I looked at the scoreboard, and it was tough to see. But either way, that's a JV level. It's hopefully the varsity can turn things around and get a W to head 90 minutes back home in a couple hours from now. Well, I'd like to thank Kane, as they are helping us out today. Kane Chevrolet Buick GMC in Oconto and Marinette. Kane driving the game to you as a number one truck destination north of Green Bay. Also, Ekmeyer Heating and Sheet Metal at 1212 18th Avenue, Menominee. They probably support the Maroons. And visit North Motorsports, the area's only full-line dealer of Honda, Can-Am, Ski-Doo, Sea-Doo, and Snapper outdoor products. From their friendly sales staff to their certified technicians, they've got you covered. Visit North Motorsports at 3711 10th Street, Menominee, or give them a call at 906-863-5592. Well, we have about 15 minutes until the opening kickoff right here on your Bay Cities Radio dial. That's right, 103.7 FM. Or if you have some friends or some children away at college, they can get it online. BayCitiesOnline.com is a website. A lot of people have been asking them where they can hear it online. That's where it's at. Just click on the WHYB link, live sports. It'll take you right there. You can't miss it. And if you want an easier way to listen to the game other than the radio, if you have a smartphone or a tablet, download the app. Just in your search field, 103.7 FM, WHYB, download the app, and you're one click away from anything that happens on your hometown radio station, especially when it's live sports. All you do is just click on the app, and it will pop right up and bring it to the broadcast. So we've got all the new technology, and even the broadcast back at home sounds crystal clear, as we're using a new type of iPhone app this season. We've been trying out, and it's been very successful so far, and it sounds a lot more clear than the normal phone line that we used to use in the past. We went from a MARTA unit back at home, then on the road we'd use a phone, the dial-up phone, or then we moved into the cell phone area, then the digital cell phones took off, and now we're just using an app, and it streams right through back to the studio, and it sounds perfect. So hopefully you'll enjoy the broadcast back at home. Well, Red Robins, it's where we're here in Antigo. Again, the Schofield Stadium is a place, and in a way it kind of looks like Walton Blesch. A little bit on a smaller scale, though. I should say the original Walton Blesch, because since the playground got put in, it doesn't look the same as here in Antigo. They do have wooden bleachers across from me, then cement bleachers right below me, and about half the size of they are back at home at Walton Blesch, except there's no cement wall around the stadium. They have a fence around it, and they have some good advertising on their east end zone, or their west end zone. So it looks pretty nice, and they have good tradition here, as a lot of people are filling into the stadiums for this one. There's a big crowd for the Menominee Maroons on the far side of the field as well. So it should be a good one here tonight. Looking forward to this. Well, I did have a chance to talk to head coach Joe Noah before I went on the air. Actually, back on Wednesday, I talked to head coach Joe Noah. Got a good interview with him, about 15 minutes worth. The sad thing is, though, is my recorder broke at about the 6-minute mark. So to tell you one thing, you're not going to get all of the interviews. So you don't get him talking about the award winners, and then we're also going to miss the talk about Anigo as a cutoff as we talk about Marinette. So I apologize for that, and I even tossed it back and forth. Should I even play the interview? But I'm going to anyways let you hear at least about 5 minutes and 45 seconds of it. I'll try to cut it off at a nice spot. So we'll go to the interview, then we'll come back with a little bit more pregame coverage, as that's all going to be coming your way right here on your hometown radio station and 103.7 FM at WHYB. Menominee Marinette, so hang tight.
Esser Glass of Menominee has over 100 years of experience in the glass business. Visit the glazing contractors at Esser's for all your glass needs, such as general glass replacement in windows and frames, custom mirrors, insulated glass units, screen replacement, or frameless glass shower doors. Esser Glass is proud to be a Menominee Maroon sponsor in the community. Esser Glass at 821 7th Street in Menominee. Maroons, have a great season and good luck.
Looking for a credit union that truly cares about you and the community you live in? Then you ought to stop and see the folks at Bayshore Credit Union. Membership is open to anyone living or working in Marinette, Menominee, and Oconto counties. Whether it's everyday banking, a new auto loan, new mortgage, even a consolidation loan, they can help. And it's never too early to start establishing good credit. Bayshore Credit Union, located at 1514 Cleveland Avenue, Marinette, they're looking forward to meeting you.
Pre-game coverage here on your Bay Cities Radio Dial. Josh Kellen, now being joined by head coach Joe Noel of your Menominee Maroons. Hey, coach, thanks for taking the time tonight to join me here on a late Wednesday evening.
Yeah, it's awesome. Kids had a good win. You know, we had a lot of jitters for that first opening game, and it happened to be the biggest game of the year for us with the M&M game. And I thought overall the effort was great. A couple miscues, mental errors, but overall I thought many facets of our program did well, offense, our defense, and our special teams. I thought our special teams were definitely the highlight of the game. Our punt return, our kickoff team, our kick return, our extra points were 7-for-7. I was really pleased with that, and that's usually one of the big question marks of the first game, especially, is the special teams, and I was really pleased with that.
Yeah, you really have to be pleased with that. Every aspect of the special teams unit you have to be really happy with. We've talked about in the years past, after the first game, we do mention the special teams with the question mark, but it's probably the first year where we haven't had to talk about that. Tremendous job all around by that group.
Yeah, the Pullman boys, they finally graduated. Their eligibility's all used up, so I was wondering who was going to take that job, and Sam Larson and Thor Fluke have been battling for that position, and right now, you know, they're both battling, but Thor Fluke, he had it rolling on Saturday afternoon with his 7-for-7, and Blake Borski was snapping, and Hunter Poquette was holding, and the rest of the kids were keeping them at bay. So it's a whole 11-man unit, and they did really well. And we're working on getting a little more depth to our kickoffs so we can keep people inside the 20, you know, to start off, so they have to earn that touchdown or any yards that they may, you know, try to get.
Yeah, any question marks would have been the distance on the kickoffs, but it really didn't matter. And if you looked at, you know, returning the ball, you guys did really well. You already see the confidence with the backs that you have on the special teams unit. So, you know, you can always nitpick some things, but overall, very well, good job on the special teams unit this week. Well, you move ahead now and take a look at your offense here. Again, congratulations on the win over Marinette at the beginning of the game, 49-21. Offense doing a really good job. Both teams froze in the first quarter. It's a typical M&M game, but you really took control of it, and you didn't look back in the second quarter, scoring 28 points in the second.
Yeah, well, you know, it's always it's a game of cat and mouse when you start offensively, because everyone has a different defensive plan and structure for taking things away from you. And they had 11 guys within 5 yards of the ball, so right away we tried to, you know, get our edge play and run up to shoot and then get outside. And we threw a couple pass plays where we just kind of missed a little bit here and there. And then, like I said, once they showed their hand, so to speak, we kind of knew where to go from there, because they had a lot of people devoted to stopping the run, which is a, you know, a smart plan. But eventually we found some seams and we went after it, found some mismatches, and we were able to exploit a couple things. But I thought what really sparked us was Ethan Molesky's punt return. And, you know, his cousin Peyton had a really nice block on that play. And I think that kind of got us going. We got in the red zone, and we we've been, you know, we only had one game thus far, but it's good when we can score when we're in the red zone.
Yeah, exactly. We just touched on the special teams in right there. The punt return by Molesky got the offense going. Two plays later, Zach Easy plowed one through, and then a little bit later, you had a fake punt set up by, you know, a special teams unit. Zach Easy again got you the first down, and Easy again had a big long touchdown run as well, 79 yards. So right there, three big plays. The fourth big play of the game was a kickoff return by Hunter Hass. So the big plays of the game completely in favor of your Menominee Maroons. The special teams setting up the way for your offense.
Yeah, and once again, the Hunter Hass situation, our kick receive, once again, we try to run through it a little bit each day in practice. Instead of doing conditioning, we'll do a special team unit, and we'll work it, and it turned out to be a good decision, I guess, because our kids really blocked well. And, you know, they called a little block in the back there on the second one. Otherwise, I don't think everyone's ever returned two kickoffs for touchdowns in an M&M game. And Hunter did a really nice job of cutting back against the flow and working it, and probably looked good from where you were sitting.
Mm-hmm.
But from ground level, it's difficult to see the openings. But he did a great job on that, and we had some really good blocking looking at the film. And once again, you know, we ran the fake punt just based on what they were doing, and we kind of got a little lucky on that because they guarded it the second or third time we punted. When we went for the fake, they did guard it, and Kiefer Raisner just made a nice play.
All right, I'm going to cut head coach Joe Noah off right there because the interview is coming to a close according to my recorder. I apologize for that for everyone back at home if you missed the start of it. I originally had the interview with head coach Joe Noah back on Wednesday night. A good interview, about 15 minutes worth, but my technology broke. I had a recorder that's about 14 years old, and it recorded the whole thing. When I looked at it, it said media error. It was blinking, and I thought it was recording, and listened to it. We only got 6 minutes of it, and that was a good time to stop, so I apologize for that. Got a new one here, so it will not happen again unless the batteries go dead, so you never know what will take place. But anyways, we are here in Antigo for the Menominee Maroons taking on the Antigo Red Robins. A terrific atmosphere here for this one. The Red Robin Marching Band is walking around the bleachers right now as they're entering the stadium, and they'll grace us with the National Anthem in a few moments as well. Again, if you missed it, the Junior Varsity Menominee Maroons played prior to this contest with the Menominee JVs scoring 18 points, but the Red Robins put up 48 on them. So the Menominee Maroon Junior Varsity team still looking for their first win of the season as they start this one off at 0-2. The Red Robins undefeated. The Varsity team undefeated so far on the year with wins over Two Rivers back in the 21st, 40-12. Then they defeated Oconto last week, 35-0. They're out of the Great Northern Conference in Wisconsin. Teams like Merrill, Medford, Lakeland, Mosinee, Rhinelander, and Ashland all in that conference. They're going to be in Ashland next week. That's the way it looks for the Antigo Red Robins. Taking a look quickly at your Menominee Maroons, of course, they're in the Great Northern Conference in the Upper Peninsula. Teams like Kingsford, Escanaba, Gladstone, and Marquette. Taking a look at the scoreboard here, Escanaba is in Petoskey tonight. Gladstone is taking on Benzie Central at the Superior Dome. Marquette is hosting at Traverse City Central, and Kingsford played a rare Thursday afternoon contest. They played yesterday afternoon at 12:30 in DeWitt. They lost to them 38-7. So looking at Kingsford's schedule, they open up against West Appear, and then they took on a very tough Division III foe in DeWitt, and DeWitt took care of them 38-7. Just a completely undermatched Flippers were against DeWitt. And Menominee will play DeWitt on homecoming on week 8, the second to the last game of the season on October 16th. So look for that in Menominee. If you want to see a good battle, Menominee hosting DeWitt towards the end of the season. It's a long way from now. Right now we're going to focus first on the Red Robins from Antigo. I'm going to take a quick break. We'll come back with a little bit more pregame coverage and your starting lineup and a whole lot more right here on your Bay City's Radio Dial.
Life insurance is one of those subjects that makes people want to change the subject rather than admit they probably don't have enough. That's why State Farm agent Tony Furton focuses on how benefits of life insurance actually live on by asking people to think in terms of life without having to sell the house insurance or life without having to give up college insurance. Find out how the benefits of life insurance can live on for your family. Call State Farm agent Tony Furton in Menominee at 906-863-4464 and put the life back in life insurance. Prestige Auto Body and Truck Repair has over 25 years of experience to make your repairs fast, easy, and worry-free. With around-the-clock towing, electronic estimating, early drop-off, pickup, delivery, and the comfort of knowing Prestige Auto Body and Truck Repair is an iCar Gold Class shop, one of only 25 in the state. Located on the corner of Highway 64 and 180 in Marinette. Call 715-732-4544. That's 715-732-4544 to get your estimate today. Prestige Auto Body and Truck Repair. They take the worry out of your collision repair. Stop in at Colonel K's Pasties to get a taste of the UP. Choose from their large variety of delicious homemade pasties, fresh or frozen, homemade soups made daily, coffee of the day, and their amazing soft serve ice cream. Make Colonel K's your breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Dine in, pick up, or drive through. You can't go wrong when you choose Colonel K's. Colonel K's Pasties, located on 10th Street in Menominee. The friendly food shaped like a smile. Stop in and pick up or drive through today.
And our pregame coverage here brought to you by North Motorsports, the area's only full-line dealer of Honda, Can-Am, Ski-Doo, Sea-Doo, and Snapper Outdoor products. From their friendly sales staff to their certified service technicians, they've got you covered. Visit North Motorsports at 3711 10th Street in Menominee or give them a call at 906-863-5592. And I'm Josh Kellner. Glad you're hanging out with me again this evening. A gorgeous night for football. Honestly, it's actually a little too warm. Not used to this. Hot up here in the press box, but it's mid-upper 70s down below, and it's a little humid, a little sticky, but it's all right. It'll cool down. The sun starts to set a little bit more. It's already behind the trees here to the west, and it's to my right side here in Antigo. As the Antigo marching band is directly in front of me now, they'll bring us a national anthem, and when they do that, we will send it down to the field to bring you the national anthem as well, right here on your Bay City's radio dial. Looking forward to seeing their quarterback, Alex Nagel, a fantastic player in him, a starting senior. He's been the starting quarterback for a couple years now. 6 foot, 177 pounds, and he's an all-around athlete that they have. And they got some talented backs in backfield as well. A couple wingbacks in Caleb Hunter and Max Nowinski. I remember that young man from last year as well. And then their big fullback is Will Dixon, 5'7", 173-pound bowling ball that they have. So they got a lot of key elements here for the Antigo Red Robins. The Menominee Bruins are going to try to contain coming up this evening. And, of course, for Menominee, look for big things from Zach Giese. Everybody knows about Zach Giese. I talked to the radio station here from Antigo, and he knew right away. Number 44, I'm going to keep my eyes on him. So look for Giese to have a big game. But then also don't take your eyes off of Nathan Nowak and keep erasing him. When one is in the backfield at the hillback position, the other one will be at wingback. So they will not lead the field at all. And Ethan Molesky will be the other wingback, depending on the formation. So we'll have to wait and see what happens. Hunter Haas will get some more plays on the offensive side of things this week as well, as he had a 90-yard kickoff return for a touchdown to open up the second half against Marinette last week. Then he had an 85-yard return that was called back because of a block in the back. So a lot of big things coming from Hunter Haas, and Coach Noah wants to see if he can get him out on the field a little bit more. And as the Menominee Bruins are really deep, actually, in that position this year. And we haven't even seen Tanner Mathias yet. Maybe tonight Mathias will step out, as the Menominee Bruins have a real good tight end in Tanner. And they just didn't really have a reason to get him the ball last game, as the Menominee Bruins took care of Marinette 49-21. All right, let's send it down to the field for the Antigo Red Robins marching band. As their team comes out from the locker room, and it's going to be interesting to watch today because their colors are the exact same as the Menominee Bruins. Looks like they're maroonish, except they have maroon shirts tonight with white shorts, while the Bruins have the white shirts tonight in the maroon pants. But white helmets for Menominee, and like the maroonish with silver wings on the side for the Antigo Red Robins.
Finally, as those who are able to please stand.
As both teams are in single file line, getting ready to look at the national flag as they'll wave Old Glory from the west end zone. So I'm going to stand up. We're going to head right back down to the field again for the national anthem from the Antigo Marching Band. Thank you. fine job by the Antigo marching band. Terrific job down below by them. As they will get ready to exit the field, I'm going to go over this evening's starting lineup for your team back at home, the Menominee Maroons. On the left side of the line, the left end for Menominee will be number 22, a 6-foot, 190-pound senior, Peyton Molesky. The left tackle, a 5'9", 255-pound junior, Kyle Desitel. The left guard, a 5'7", 155-pound senior, number 55, Connor Smith, snapping the ball. A 5'10", 187-pound senior, number 53, Andrew Lindman. As we head to the right side of the line, the starting right guard for the Menominee Maroons, a 5'9", 187-pound, or a 5'9", 155-pound junior, number 62, Jacob Zimba. The right tackle is a 6'3", 280-pound senior, number 77, Logan Eakey. The right end of this evening for the Menominee Maroons will be a 6'4", 225-pound junior, number 49, Tanner Mathias. As we head to the backfield now for the Menominee Maroons, the starting wingback coming for Menominee will be a 6'1", 181-pound sophomore, number 15, Ethan Molesky. Rotating that wingback and tailback, we'll give you these two young men, number 36, Nathan Nowak, who is a 5'10", 180-pound senior. Rotating with him will be a 5'10" junior, 175-pound Kiefer Reisner, Reisner number 14. If one is at tailback, the other one will be at wingback and vice versa. The starting fullback this evening for Menominee, a 6'190-pound senior, number 44, Zach Geezy. We'll also see some wingback position played by Sam Larson, a 5'10", 170-pound junior, Larson number 34. It's 12 players. They'll rotate things, and you'll get things all squared away as this evening will commence. Kicking off tonight will be Sam Larson for the Menominee Maroons. As Antigo won the toss, they elected to receive, and they will travel from east to west here in Antigo. From left to right on your Bay Cities radio dial, from the scoreboard to concession stand here at Schofield Stadium. Again, glad that you join me here. I'm Josh Kellner. The candles are lit. The lights are starting to come on. All set for some great football tonight here at Schofield Stadium in Antigo. Again, pregame coverage brought to you by North Motorsports. Stop in the area's only full-line dealer of Honda, Can-Am, Ski-Doo, Sea-Doo, and Snap-Or outdoor products. Sam Larson gets all set to kick it off. He'll get a toe into it, a line drive wobbling kick. This will be fielded at the 8-yard line. Bobbled to the backfield, but picked up across the 25-30, still on his feet, 35-yard line, and roped down and brought down above the 38-yard line. As the Menominee Maroon special teams unit brings down a Cody DeLow on the kick return. And now we will get to see Alex Nagel take the field for the Antigo Red Robins. He threw a 25-yard touchdown pass to Zach Lewis against Two Rivers. Let's see what he does here tonight. As Red Robins are 2-0 on the season. So first down and 10 coming up from their own at the 38-yard line. One receiver to the left. Everyone else inside. Quick handoff up the middle. Hit and brought down immediately. Nowhere to go. Maybe a short gain of a yard. And a quick hitter up the middle. I believe it's in the vicinity of Will Dixon, and it was Will Dixon on the carry. So a gain to the 39-yard line for a one-yard pickup for Will Dixon. So Will Dixon starts things off for the Antigo Red Robins. From their own 39-yard line in the right hash, directly in front of me here, wing on the right side, a wing off to the left, and one back behind Nagel. Option, pitch it out to the left side, trying to cut it up. Now a hit and met at the 40-yard line and brought down immediately Max Nowinski. And Nowinski was hit and drilled as soon as he got that pitch and took a step forward to gain a yard. So a one-yard pickup that time for Max Nowinski. It was almost set up like an option, but it wasn't an option. The quarterback of Nagel pitched it immediately, bringing up a third down and eight situation now from the 40-yard line for the Red Robins. Head coach Thomas Schofield is first year at the helm. We got a lot to learn from his father and grandfather of each coach this team and brought home state titles. Receiver wide to the right, Nagel bootlegging to the right side. Pressure now coming from the weak side. Pump fake once, floats over to the right side. It's up and it's well incomplete. Overshot his intended receiver, Max Nowinski. And the Menominee Maroon defensive backs in terrific coverage. And basically, Nagel had to throw that one away as he was running out of real estate. And the pass will drop incomplete. Stop the clock with 10:38 remaining. And they will send the punt team out to try to kick this one away. As a Maroon sophomore, Ethan Molesky will drop back to return this one. Back at his own 25-yard line. And Alex Nagel to kick this one away as well. Back at his own 25-yard line. Low snap. He'll pick it up and boot this one. Ethan Molesky on the run. He'll pick it up at his own 28-yard line. Molesky to the 30, to the 40. Ethan Molesky still on his feet across midfield. Molesky hit, driven forward, brought down to the 42-yard line. So a nice little run that time for Ethan Molesky on that punt return.
Down to the Robin.
And the Menominee Maroons will now send their offensive unit on the field for the first time coming up this evening. First down and 10. They'll spot the ball on the 43-yard line. As the Menominee Maroons are out there. Here we go. Everybody in tight. Wing on each side from the right hash. And flags will fly. The Maroons possibly have jumped a tad early on this one. And it's going to be a procedure penalty. Actually, the hard count got the Red Robins to jump. So a penalty on Anigo to start this one off. So the Red Robins jump forward, putting the ball now on the Menominee, or on the Antigo 37-yard line with that penalty. So the 29-yard punt return for Molesky set the Maroons now. First down and 5 from the 37-yard line. Nowat tried to bounce to the outside, going to the right, upended as he gets to the 35-yard line. Hard-fought 2-yard pickup for Nathan Nowat, trying to use his speed and quickness to get around the end. And he gains a couple of yards. So Nathan Nowak bringing up the Maroons now with a second down and a 3 after that 2-yard pickup. Right at the 35 as they're to mark him down. And the Maroons will break huddle again underneath the helm of head coach Joe Noah. Wing on each side now. Geezy and Razor into the backfield. Razor now wants to run to the left side. Keeper wants to cut up and he's hit hard right at the 35-yard line. Got to the line of scrimmage. Nice tackle by Cody Bello. As no one picked him up, Bello came through the line from his linebacking position and put a shoulder right into the midsection of Razor and dropped him immediately. So Razor's first call of the game with nowhere to go. Now Menominee a third down and two, or I'm sorry, a third down and 3 from the 35-yard line. And Nathan Nowak back in at the tailback position, center of the field, right on the 35. Molesky a wing to the left, Hunter Haas a wing to the right side. Nowak and Geezy into the backfield. Nowak, a couple hard counts, puts Molesky in motion from left to right, and up the middle, Zach Geezy. Geezy cuts it forward, slides his way. I think he's going to be a little bit shy of that first down marker. Needed to get 3. I think he picked up 1, maybe 2 yards. It might just give him a gain of 1 as the hole collapsed for Zach Geezy. So Geezy gains a yard on that carry. And the Maroons have a 4th down and a 2 from the Antigo 34-yard line on the right hash. At the linebacking core right now by the Red Robins, doing a great job reading their keys. Ethan Molesky a wing to the left. Nowak in at tailback. Geezy right to his right side. Nowak back to pass. Looks to zip it over the middle. Has his man. It's Matthias. Matthias hauls it in and he's hammered down immediately inside the 25 to about the 22-yard line. Nice quick pass. Matthias hit a little bit early on that one, but he managed to hold on and move the chains now for the Menominee Maroons to give them their first down of the game. So a nice pass that time from Nowak to hit him. And they spot the ball all the way to the 22 on that 12-yard gain. So a 12-yard pickup from Nowak to Matthias. Kiva Razor, hands off the ball to the ground, bobbled everywhere, still in the air. Who has it? The Maroons dive in for it from here. It looks like the Red Robins have it. Ethan Molesky on the wingback trap, his first carry as a Menominee Maroon. He bobbled it and he lost it, and the Red Robins will get the ball.
Bello with the fumble recovery.
As Bello gets a fumble recovery. And the Maroons will turn it over. So the fumble on Menominee. In Antigo territory, it was at the 22-yard line. Now the ball is in the 16 where the Maroons had it, where the Red Robins will take over. So first down and 10 for Nagel from his own 16-yard line. Hand off up the middle, hit after he got a few yards, close to the 20-yard line for a 4-yard pickup. I believe is their big fullback again. Oh.
Dixon.
And I think it's going to be Will Dixon getting the call. So Will Dixon picks up 4.
Second and 6.
For the Red Robins. And a nice little run there. So a second down and a 6 from the 20-yard line is where they spot it. Antigo again going left to right here on your Bay Cities radio dial. Alex Nagel, under center, man in motion from left to right. Little handoff up the middle again. I believe it's Dixon, and Dixon driven backwards as soon as he had the ball. Maybe a loss of one, depending on where they gave him forward progress. And they will give him a loss of one back to the 19. So the one-yard loss for Will Dixon. With the Menominee Maroon defensive front all over Dixon on that call. Bringing up another third down situation for the Red Robins. Third down and seven from the 19. Head coach Tom Schofield has his play altitude quarterback, Alex Nagel. Bill Breakuddle. He'll send Luke Berner wide to the left side. Hunter Haas hops on him defensively. Man in motion, the wing. From right to left, bootlegging left side. They set up a screen pass up, and it's caught by Dixon, who's brought down immediately at the 28-yard line. Nice tackle coming up by Drew Baxter to stay with them, and it's just enough to get the first down. Needed 7 yards. A screen pass got him about eight, all the way to the 33-yard line. I'm sorry, the 28-yard line is where it was. So a 9-yard pickup, actually, on that screen pass. So Nagel gets his first completion of the game. The counter hit at the 30-yard line, then driven back by Ethan Molesky, also there in the tackle for the Menominee Maroons is Sam Larson. A 3-yard pickup to about the 31.
Nowinski on the carry.
So Max Nowinski picking up that one.
Maybe three, taken down by Baxter.
Drew Basker on that. Thanks. So the Antigo Red Robins now facing a second down and about seven. And they'll break huddle. Everybody in tight. One back to the back to the wing, deep off the right side. Bootlegging to the right now, looking to run is Nagel. Nagel looking for some blocking, has a hold to the 35-yard line. Stiff arms and room. Defender to the knock out of bounds at about the 45-yard line. Nice run for Alex Nagel, being very patient and following his blockers. The Bruins lit up the blockers, but they lit him up so strong that Nagel then just went right past him. All the way to the 44 is where they're going to spot this one. 13-yard gain. Nice little run that time for Alex Nagel. His first carry of the game. And they have a fresh set of downs. First down and 10. From their own 44 on the right hash. Wing on the right, split back to the backfield. Nowinski is in motion from right to left. Now the receiver wide to the right. Quick spin, nowhere to go. Maybe a broken play or just a little head fake as Alex Nagel spun and then carried the ball up the hole to the left side. And they're going to give him a short gain of one. Not much, but round up, it's close to a yard for Alex Nagel. Tanner Mathias in the tackle that time for Menominee. Bringing up a second down and nine with the ball placed on the 45. Scoreless here in Antigo, 5:15 to go. We're in the first quarter. The Maroons, one series so far today. They fumbled the ball in Antigo territory at the 16-yard line. The wing on the left, split back to the back of the game behind Alex Nagel. The wing in motion from left to right. Nagel spins, fakes hand up, back to pass. Mathias applying some pressure now. And he's forced out of the pocket, throws a high, and it's nearly intercepted by Nathan Nowak, and it slipped through his fingers. If he would have caught it, though, he possibly would have been out of bounds. But a good effort there, and good defensive presence by Tanner Mathias from his end position to apply the pressure as Alex Nagel tosses that one away. It'll be a second down, or a third down and nine now, still from the 45-yard line for Alex Nagel. And his head coach, Tom Schofield, has his play out there to his team with 4:54 remaining in this opening quarter. They'll send a receiver wide to the left side and Luke Berner. Slot left as well. One back to Nagel and the whole left side of the field for the Red Robins jumps offside. So their second penalty of the game. This will bring up a third down and a 14 now. Back to the 40. So third down and 14 for the Red Robins. As the Menominee Maroon defense tries to stiffen here and get the ball back and put the wing back out on the field. Luke Berner wide to the right side from the center of the field. A wing on the left, split back to the backfield behind Alex Nagel. Nagel, two-step drop, fakes the pass, hands off, trying to bounce to the outside. The Maroons are all over that. No gain, no loss as they tried to hand off to Caleb Hunter on the counter. And Hunter had it nowhere to go. Hunter, 5'8", 150-pound senior.
Hunter on the carry, taken down by Molesky.
That's his first carry of the game. Peyton Molesky on the tackle that time for Menominee, bringing up a fourth down and 15. As Ethan Molesky will drop back to return this one. Currently standing at his own 30-yard line. And Nagel will punt this one away on his own 27. As Ethan Molesky checking over the situation. The snap is there. Nagel will get a foot into it. This one's a high, long one, and Molesky's backing up. He bobbled the ball. It's on the ground right now, and it looks like the Red Robins fall on it. Ethan Molesky was running backwards, and it slipped through his fingers. And another turnover on the Menominee Maroons on the fumble. And this one's deep in Menominee territory. As missed the person to recover that one for the Antigo Red Robins. We had to wait 3:57 to go at the 23-yard line. The Antigo Red Robins will have it in Menominee territory. And they'll put a man in motion from left to right. Nagel spins, hands off, and hit and brought down after a gain of a couple. As
Dixon
trying to get some yards, and he does. It's about the 22. So it'll be the 1 yard pickup coming up for Dixon. And now it'll be a second down and 9 at the Menominee 22-yard line. 3:28 to go, first quarter. Two turnovers on the Menominee Maroons on Ethan Molesky fumbles. Receiver wide to the right side. It'll be Luke Berner again. Slip backs backfield behind Nagel. Nagel spins, fakes handoff, now wants to run to the left side. The Maroons trying to catch up with him. He'll bounce and get the edge. The 10 to the 5. Touchdown, Alex Nagel. 22-yard touchdown run for Alex Nagel. And the Red Robins will strike first with 3:10 remaining in this first quarter. Only give them enough opportunities with the ball, they're going to put points on the board. As the Red Robins, a decent football team. As they'll wait the extra point. Coming from Mitchell Wagner to try to kick this one through. Snap is there. Nagel's hold. The kick is up, and the kick is wobbly, but it is good. So, your score with 3:10 to go in the first quarter. Antigo 7, Menominee nothing. Back after this.
Farmers and Merchants Bank and Trust offers a variety of loan programs. Vehicle loans, personal loans, and commercial loans. They do real estate mortgages, offer home equity options, and work with government loan programs. Farmers and Merchants Bank and Trust is here to serve you in three locations. Ludington Street in Marinette, Roosevelt Road in Marinette, and Highway 141 in Crivitz. They can show you how to make your banking life easier, save you time, and save you money. Contact them today. Farmers and Merchants Bank and Trust, member FDIC.
And back in right here in your hometown radio station, 103.7 FM, WHYB, Menominee and Marinette, and BayCitiesOnline.com. Well, a 22-yard touchdown run by Alex Nagel gives Red Robins a 7-0 lead with 3:10 to go in the first quarter, according to that Johnson Sewer Cleaning scoreboard. Hunter Kirsch to kick off for the Red Robins, and it's going to be Mitchell Boucher from his own 19-yard line. Boucher to the 20, to the 30-yard line, still pushing his way forward to the 35. And nice little return for Mitchell Boucher. Now the Menominee Maroon offense will head back out onto the field. After they had the ball for one series, they drove to the 22-yard line, and they fumbled it at the 16. The Red Robins drove, the Maroon defense stopped them, but the fumbled punt gave the Red Robins ball back at the 22-yard line, 23-yard line. 2 plays later, they punched it in. So first down and 10 from the 36 for the Maroons with 3:04 to go in the first quarter. Two receivers right, two to the left. Giesey and Nowak into the backfield. Nowak quick pass over to the right side, in and out of the hands, dropped on the right flats, intended for keeper Reisner. Reisner took his eyes off the ball, and the pass will fall incomplete on the quick pass to the right side. Noah from Nathan Noah. Easy pass, just complete. Dropped on that far side. So second down and 10 now for the Maroons from the 36. The ball placed center of the field. Now you have Menominee down 7-0. Hunter Hass wide to the right side, slot right, Peyton Molesky. Slot left, Ethan Molesky. Wide to the left coming my way. And it's going to be Spencer Howell. The snap to Reisner. Reisner wants to run out the middle. He'll push and Pickens chooses his way, tried to bounce to the outside, breaking tackle, still on his feet, pushing the pile to the 40-yard line. For a progress, he might give him the 40. Looks like it might be the 39, though, from here. As the Maroons spread out the Red Robins, and Reisner gets a call. For progress, they will give him the 40. Still a gain of 4 for the Maroons and keeper Reisner. So Reisner's second carry of the game puts them in the positive yardage category. Third down and 6 now for the Maroons on their own 40. Two receivers left, two more to the right side. Into the backfield, Nathan Nowak and Zach Giese down to the three-point stance to his right. Ethan Molesky in motion from left to right. Nowak wants to run to the right side. Nowak cuts it up. Now has a hold of the 45 across midfield. Nathan Nowak breaks away to the 40. Nathan Nowak to the 30. Brought down from behind to the 25-yard line. Nice strong run for Nathan Nowak using his speed and his running ability. Made a few cutbacks to Zach Giese. Sprung him from the fullback position with a good T block. All the way to the Antigo 24-yard line. So a 36-yard run for Nathan Nowak gives the Maroons the first down. And a good one at that. First down and 10 from the right hash at the Antigo 24. A wing on the left and a wing on the right side. As Reisner and Giese into the backfield. Molesky in motion from left to right. They want to run the left side. Reisner trying to get the edge. Reisner sweeps, lowers his shoulder, and he's upended at about the 23.
Reisner on the carry.
If Reisner would have cut it up instead of trying to go wide, he might have got a couple extra yards. But he went wide around the defender and got a hard-fought one-yard gain.
Picks up one, second and 9.
And it'll be a second down and 9 now for Menominee. 100 seconds to go, first quarter. 7-0 Red Robins. As Andrew Linen has a call from tailback Nathan Nowak as they break huddle. Ethan Molesky, a wing to the left. Reisner, a wing to the right. Giese and Nowak, fullback, tailback combination into the backfield. Nowak has a call. Bootlegged to the right, looking to pass. Zips over the middle. Mathias to the 10. Mathias to the 5. He'll dive in. Close to the end zone. Touchdown, Menominee. Somehow the ball broke the plane on that right side, and he hauls it in with both hands on it, leaned across, and he got the touchdown. 1:09 remaining in this first quarter. Tanner Mathias gets it from Nathan Nowak. And he gets his first catch of, or second catch of the season, second catch today. This one's a 23-yard touchdown.
Mathias on the touchdown catch for the Maroons.
So the Maroons answer quickly for the touchdown. Thor Fuchs, extra point, up and good. Thor, tied up at 7, 69 seconds to go. First quarter, back after this.
Where can you go to get a bite to eat before or after the game? Dexter's. Dexter's in Menominee has enough seating for the whole team and a menu to fit everyone's taste and appetite. Or call ahead and take your order to go. Dexter's looks forward to seeing you this year. Good luck to all M&M sports participants. Dexter's, located on 10th Avenue in Menominee. Check out their menu online at dextersrestaurantonline.com and like us on Facebook.
And back at it right here on your hometown radio station, 103.7 FM, WHYB, Menominee and Marinette, BayCitiesOnline.com. 23-yard touchdown pass from Nathan Nowak to hit Tanner Mathias, tying the ball game up at 7 after Thor Fluke's extra point being good. Your Johnson Sewer Cleaning scoreboard now reads 7-7 with 1:09 remaining. Give Kent or Deanna a call at Johnson Sewer Cleaning, 715-732-0427. And Fluke will tee it up at the 40-yard line. Short, high, end over and kick. Bounces at the 30. Takes the Maroon bounce. And the Red Robins somehow dive on it at the last second. As Caleb Hunter will down it. Inside the 35. Let's see the spot that they're going to give him.
Recovers the kick.
I'd say about the 32, maybe the 33-yard line.
30.
They haven't placed the ball in down.
First and 10, Antioch.
I'll give him the 33. So 33-yard line, first down and 10 for the Antigo Red Robins. As Alex Nega will break huddle. Wide to the right side, they'll send Luke Berner. Nathan Nowak hops on him defensively. Split backs back behind Alex Nagel under center. Nagel spins, hands off, hit, sheds the first tackle, now trying to bounce to the middle of the field. Still pushing his way forward. Nice strong run brought down to the 38-yard line. Max Dewinsky getting the call. Had him in the backfield was Adam Beiersdorf, but Beiersdorf couldn't seem to hold on. And Nowinski picks up 5 yards. So a 5-yard pickup that time for Nowinski. He's got 3 carries, number 12 yards. Three carries for 9 yards, rather, right now for Max Nowinski. Second down and 5 from their own 38-yard line. 27 seconds to go, first quarter, tied at 7. Man in motion, the wing from left to right. They'll hand it off to him, trying to bounce to the inside. Cutting it up was Max Nowinski again. Nowinski gains a yard, or about 2 yards, to the 40-yard line. So a 2-yard pickup for Nowinski.
Jacob
Caster, he gets a tackle. And 4 seconds of ticking, this may do it for the first quarter. So at the end of one here in Anago, it is the Red Robins at 7, your Menominee Maroons at 7. We'll switch sides of the field and come back to the second quarter after this in your Bay City's Radio Dial.
Life insurance is one of those subjects that make people want to change the subject. I'm State Farm Agent Brent Merritt, and that's why I focus on how the benefits of life insurance actually live on, by asking people to think in terms of life without having to sell the house insurance, or life without having to give up college insurance. Find out how the benefits of life insurance can live on for your family. Contact me, State Farm Agent Brent Merritt, serving Wisconsin and Michigan.
Menards is a place to save big money on all your home improvement needs. Whether you're building or remodeling, Menards has everything you need for your home under one roof. From building materials and tools to paint, carpeting, cabinets, and all the finishing touches, you'll find quality products, helpful friendly service, and delivery 7 days a week. And at Menards, you'll always find the lowest prices and sales, too.
Save big money at Menards.
And back at it right here in your hometown radio station, 103.7 FM, WHYB, Menominee Mariners, and BayCitiesOnline.com. At the end of the first quarter, it is the Menominee Maroons and the Antigo Red Robins all tied up at 7 apiece. 2 fumbles by the Menominee Maroons. That really hurt them in this ballgame. As Menominee 79 yards, total offense, and they go 61. But again, 2 turnovers by Menominee. Third down and a 3 coming up for the Red Robins on the 40-yard line, their own 40. They will now go from right to left in your Bay City's radio dial. West to east here in Anago. As man in motion from right to left, Nagel will fake the handoff. Now try to bounce to the outside. Has a first down hit and wrapped up at the 44-yard line. Move the chains. 3-yard pickup for Alex Nagel. Just enough to move the chains from here. Looks like they have it. They will not measure. So a 3-yard pickup for Alex Nagel. And Antigo will get the first down.
Bowen on the tackle by for the Maroons.
So a first down and 10 for the Red Robins from their own 44-yard line here in the second quarter. And now we have a timeout called by the Menominee Maroons. The defense wants to talk some things over. Timeout down below. We'll take a quick one as well back after this.
Let me tell you, Advanced Motors, located in Coleman, has AMSOIL for all your motorcycle, ATV, marine, and vehicle needs. AMSOIL, the first in synthetics. Are you or your student moving? Advanced Motors, a U-Haul dealer, also carries packing and moving supplies for all your needs. Stop in or call today at 920-897-2677. That's 920-897-2677. Whew, that's right.
Peshtigo National Bank, your locally owned independent community bank, supports all local high school sports. Since opening in 1901, they've grown to 5 locations in Peshtigo, Coleman, Ocado Falls, Gillett, and Marinette. Hometown banking with your neighbors and friends, Peshtigo National Bank has proudly served the community for over 100 years. Locally owned community banks support and help fund local projects. Keep your banking local and speak with a representative today. Good luck to all area high school teams from Peshtigo National Bank, member FDIC.
After the timeout call by the Menominee Maroons, back in action right here on your Bay City's radio dial. It'll be a first down and 10 for the Red Robins. So the receiver wide to the right side, wing in motion from left to right. Quick handoff up the middle, pushing his way forward, then hit and brought down after a gain of 2 was Duwill Dixon again. As the Menominee Maroon defensive front all over Dixon, it'll bring up now a second down and 8. As he was popped pretty hard once he got past the line of scrimmage for the short gain of a couple. From the left hash of the 46-yard line, the Red Robins will have it. Luke Berner wide to the left side. A wing on the left also split backs to the backfield behind Nagel. Nagel spins, fakes the handoff, bootlegging to the right side, wants a run now. The Maroon defense trying to stick with him. Flags fly, but Nathan Nowak is there for the break hit and the burn down back to the 40-yard line for a 7-yard loss, and the penalty is going to be a holding penalty. Let's see if the Menominee Maroons will take it in, decline it with the big sack with Nathan Nowak around the right side. Nice run that time for Nowak. Holding penalty. Red Robins and the Maroons will decline it, as this will be a 7-yard loss. All the way back to a third down and a 14 situation. So a 7-yard loss for Nagel to make it a third and a 14 situation. So Alex Nagel has gone from head coach Tom Schofield. With 11 minutes remaining in the first half, we're tied at 7 here in Antigo. And they will break huddle, burner wide to the left side. Slot left will be Elijah Wickersheim. Wing on the left. One back coming up behind him. Nagel bootlegs to the left side. Looking to pass. Pressure on coming. He wants to float it right side for Wickersheim. It's off and it's caught. At the 30-yard line, he'll break the tackle and take it to the 10 to the 5. Touchdown. As a Maroon defensive back just flat out got burnt on the left side. As he was staring at the ball go over his head. He had him by the toes, but couldn't seem to hold on to him. And Wickersheim ran the rest of the way. A 60-yard touchdown pass from Alex Nagel. And the Red Robins will take the ball right back. As we await their extra point. The kick is up, and the kick is good. So 10:32 to go in the second quarter. It is 14-7 Red Robins. Back after this in your Bay City's radio dial.
Menza and Zach, your local Tempstar dealer. Experts in heating, cooling, and sheet metal. Fully insured in Michigan and Wisconsin. For your residential, commercial, and light industrial needs. Serving all brands, installation in new construction and remodels. Along with preventative furnace and air conditioner maintenance. 24-hour emergency service available. Check out their website to see a full list of services offered at MenzaandZach.com. Located at 60 Water Street in Marinette.
And back deep. For the Menominee Maroons, Hunter Hassan, Mitchell Boucher, as Alex Nagel hit Elijah Wickersheim for a 60-yard touchdown pass. And the PAT is good, making the game 7-14 in favor of the Antigo Red Robins. As we wait the kickoff coming from Hunter Kirsch, and he'll get a line drive kick. I don't think it was an onside. He just missed it, fielded by one of the Menominee Maroons' middlemen. And he's driving his way to the 40, 41 yard. They're holding him up, trying to strip the ball. The whistles will blow. As it was a Menominee Maroon lineman, basically, on the return. Braden Wickstrom for the Maroons. Put both hands in the ball and just Wickstrom ran forward to the 41. So the Maroons have it, first and 10 on their own 41 yard line. 10:25 to go in this first half. 14-7, Red Robins. Keep it raising their wing to the right. Ethan Molesky, wing to the left. Nowak and Giese into the backfield. First down and 10 from the 41-yard line. Their own 41 on the right hash. Nowak up the middle, trying to bounce to the outside. He's hit, then brought down after he gains a yard. As Nathan Nowak tried to bounce it.
Nowak on the carry.
As he gets a hard fought 1-yard gain to the 42. This is a 1-yard pickup. As Nowak now has 39 yards on 3 carries for the Maroons. Second and 9, 10 minutes to go, first half. Again, Antigo on top as he leads this one by a touchdown and the extra point, 14-7. Nowak a wing to the right side. Ethan Molesky a wing to the left. Keeper Razor in it, tailback. Giese right to his left side. Molesky, next chance, Keeper Razor wants to run. Razor trying to bounce and go wide. Razor, the 45, still on his feet, shy of the 50 where he's brought down. Stayed in bounds on that far side of the field. As Keeper Razor picks up at 7 yards, his largest gain of the night.
Razor on the carry. Taken down by
all the way to about the
47-yard
line.
For the Maroons.
So 47, or to the 47-yard line. After that game, bringing up a third down and a 4, only a 5-yard gain, rather. Coming up for Razor. And they're going to hand it off to Zach Giese. He's trying to bounce up the middle now, and Giese gets the first down. He's forced out of bounds after he got a yard extra after that, picking up about 6 yards. See where they spot the ball on that far side.
Giese on the
into Antigo territory, rather.
The Maroon first down.
They're going to spot it at their 47-yard line.
First and 10 on the
so a 6-yard gain on the far side of the field that time for Zach Giese. As that was only his second carry of the game. First down and 10, but now only from the left hash. Reisner and Giese into the backfield. Reisner wants to run with Giese leading the way. Reisner cuts it up now to the 45, bounces to the outside of the 40. Keep it, Reisner to the 30, still on his feet to the 25, and brought down at about the 23-yard line. Nice run for Kiefer Reisner again. A nice block for Zach Giese to spring Kiefer Reisner. They cut it up the middle and used his moves to move the chains. So a first down for Menominee. Bring up a first down and 10. All the way to the Antigo. Let's see where they spot it. 24-yard line. So the 24 for the 23-yard gain for Kiefer Reisner. This time it's Nowak up the middle. Nathan Nowak will dive his way to the 20, maybe the 19-yard line. Nice run for Nathan Nowak.
Nowak on the carry, taken down by Schrepper.
As Nowak gains
second and five.
About 5 yards to the 19. So Nathan Nowak gives the Maroons a second down and five from the left hash. Molesky wing to the left, Nowak wing to the right side. Reisner and Giese into the backfield. 8-10 to go, first half, 14-7 Red Robins. Reisner wants to bounce the outside again. He'll cut it up, slips one defender across a 15-yard line and has enough for the first down. Brought down at about the 13, maybe the 12.
Reisner on the carry, taken down by...
Reisner got real low on that run, made the defender whiff on him, and he got the extra yards and gets the Maroon first down. All the way to the 12 on a 7-yard pickup. So a 7-yard gain for Kiefer Reisner. Reisner now wing to the right, Molesky wing to the left. Nowak and Giese into the backfield. It'll be Nathan Nowak to run. Nowak trying to bounce to the outside with Giese blocking. Trying to get around the edge. His stiff arm does get him around the edge, and he's brought down shy of that first down marker, but another strong run for Nathan Nowak. He's got a good stiff arm that's getting him that extra
Nowak
running room.
The carry.
With 7:33 to go, a 9-yard pickup on that far side of the field.
Second and one.
So the 9-yard gain for Nathan Nowak. So second and one on that far side of the field at about the 4-yard line. Wing on the left, wing on the right, Zach Giese has called. Giese spinning and pushing his way forward. Giese stretching out, and he's brought down shy of the end zone, but has enough of the first down. So Zach Giese dives his way forward, move the chains to give the Maroons a first and goal. At about the 2-yard line.
For first down, taken down by Jensen. First and goal, Maroons.
So first and goal, Menominee. We'll stay at the 2. After the 2-yard Giese pickup. Snap up the middle. Diving his way forward. Is he in? Touchdown, Menominee. Zach Giese. Quick hitter, late call, but Giese got in. And the Menominee Maroons will answer to bring themselves within 1 point of the Red Robins.
Giese on the...
So Zach Giese
touchdown.
Gets a 2-yard touchdown run. Got the 7:08 mark. As we await Thor Fluke for the extra point. Snap is there, the hold. The kick by Fluke is high, real high. Did it get over? And it did. It's good. Didn't know if it went too high over that left upright, but he did split him. So Fluke's extra point is good. Tying the game up at 14. Back after this in your Bay Cities radio dial.
Esser Glass of Menominee has over 100 years of experience in the glass business. Visit the glazing contractors at Esser's for all your glass needs, such as general glass replacement in windows and frames, custom mirrors, insulated glass units, screen replacement, or frameless glass shower doors. Esser Glass is proud to be a Menominee Maroon sponsor in the community. Esser Glass at 821 7th Street in Menominee. Maroons, have a great season and good luck.
7 minutes and 8 seconds remaining on that Johnson Sewer Cleaning scoreboard here in the second quarter. As Zach Giese just had a 2-yard touchdown run, Thor Fluke's extra point being good. Knots things up 14-14 here on your Bay Cities radio dial. Fly safe tonight. As Sam Larson teases them up at the 40. High, long, end over, and kick gives it at about the 13-yard line. 15 to the 20, 25 to the big hole, 30, 35. Bounce to the outside to the 40-yard that's been brought down by the Menominee Maroons.
Winter on the return for Robert Duffy.
Touchdown, saving tackle that time by Jacob Rennie on the Menominee Maroons. Nice return for Elijah Wickersham. It's either him or Cody Below. They're turning the way, a good one at that, giving Red Robins first down and 10 at their own 41-yard line. So first down and 10 from the 41 in the right hash. And the Red Robins will break huddle. Tied up at 14. Split back to the backfield behind Alex Nagel. One hard cone, he'll spin, handoff, hit, and hammer down immediately for a loss. With Max Nowinski on that right side, three Maroons are all over that play. With Peyton Molesky leading the way for Menominee.
Nowinski.
Well, they're going to give it a 5-yard loss with 6:43 remaining in this second quarter.
Taken down by Molesky and Mathias.
We're going to see a 4-yard loss. That time for Nowinski. And they'll break huddle again from their own to the 36-yard line. Back to pass, Nagel, bootlegging from the left side. Pressure will come, the screen pass set up. He's hit and caught, and Razor will bring him down at the 47-yard line. The screen again is set up by Will Dixon, the second time they've run this screen pass. It's a big game. Shy the first down, as was a second and 14. Now it's a third down and 2 after that 12-yard pickup. So again, the screen pass successful for Alex Nagel. And Will Dixon. Third down and 2 for the Red Robins. Receiver wide to the right side. We got the right with split backs behind Nagel. Nagel spins, hands off, first down across midfield. Bumps to the side of the 45 to the 40. He's going to go over the 30. Trying to catch him, and he does catch him shy of the 10-yard line. Nice job. I believe it was Eric Vaughn. Yep, Eric Vaughn, a touchdown saving tackle with Max Nowinski getting the big run.
Taken down by.
From the 36-yard line. Or I'm sorry, it was the 48-yard line. All the way to the 10-yard line. So a 41-yard run for Alex Nagel. And they're going to say, ooh, first and goal right on the 10-yard line. Everybody in tight. Alex Nagel now under center. Nagel spins, hands off, and hit immediately and brought down maybe a short gain of a yard. Wait and see who the running back was.
Hunter on the carry.
Yeah, Caleb Hunter getting his call. Caleb Hunter's second carry of the game. We'll give Hunter a gain of a yard. Bring up a second down and goal from the 9-yard line for the Red Robins. One receiver wide to the right side, split backs backfield behind Nagel. Nagel bootlegging to the right, looking to pass. Had a man, but he didn't pass it right away. He's running around. Nagel trying to get to the outside, and he will make a man miss. Take it to the end zone, touchdown.
Nagel on the scramble.
9-yard, a touchdown run for Alex Nagel. And it was actually pretty easy that time for Nagel. As they go back on top again.
Wagner
right now it's 20-14 as we await the Wagner extra point. We have 4:48 remaining here in the second quarter. Snap is there, the hold, the kick is up, and the kick is good.
Wagner's kick is good.
So 21-14, Antigo on top of Menominee.
Antigo,
we'll take
Menominee
a quick break.
15.
Be back after this.
Life insurance is one of those subjects that makes people want to change the subject rather than admit they probably don't have enough. That's why State Farm agent Tony Furton focuses on how benefits of life insurance actually live on by asking people to think in terms of life without having to sell the house insurance or life without having to give up college insurance. Find out how the benefits of life insurance can live on for your family. Call State Farm agent Tony Furton in Menominee at 906-863-4464 and put the life back in life insurance.
Well, after a 9-yard touchdown run by Alex Nagel and the extra point up and good by Mitchell Wagner, gives San Diego Red Robins a 7-point lead, 21-14, with 4 minutes and 48 seconds remaining here in the first half. Hunter Hass and Mitchell Boucher back deep to return this one. Again, going left to right on your Bay Cities radio dial at Johnson's Sewer Cleaning Scoreboard. Again, 7-point lead for the Red Robins. Line drive kick. Boucher wants to field it at his own 24-yard line. Boucher has a breakaway to the 40-yard line. Gets a block, and he'd be brought down to the 47-yard line. Nice run for Mitchell Boucher. Used a little bit of speed there to streak through the hole. Look at him, the 48. Nice run for Boucher. One thing with this year's team, head coach Joe Noah is pretty pleased with his kickoff return men back there with Hunter Hass and Mitchell Boucher. Hass hasn't touched the ball yet today. He had 2 touchdowns last week. One of them called back with a penalty on the kickoff return. Mitchie Boucher has a couple of them today, both good returns. So first down and 10 for Menominee from the left hash on their own 48-yard line. 4:41 to go, second quarter. Knock into the backfield with Geezy, a wing on each side, Raisins to the right side. Ethan Molesky will go in motion from left to right. Jump pass over the middle, too high and complete. A little too high and too strong for Peyton Molesky as it goes over his head and will drop incomplete. So a quick pass from Knock to Molesky, and that will stop the clock with 4:37 to go. So Nathan Nowak, 2 of 4 passing today, 35 yards and a touchdown. Now the Maroons will face a 2nd and 10. Everyone in tight. Nowak now a wing to the right. Ethan Molesky a wing to the left. Raisner and Geezy into the backfield. Down to the 3-point stand, still set things. Kiefer Raisner wants a pass now. Pumping once for Kiefer. He wants to tuck it in and run now. Raisner will take it up and gain a yard to the 49-yard line. Raisner a little shy back there passing. One guy was on him. He just took it and run. Instead of being patient in the pocket, he'll just gain the yard. This is a 1-yard pickup for Kiefer Raisner. Bring up a 3rd and 9 from their own 49-yard line for Menominee. 4:10 remaining and ticking here in this second quarter. Ethan Molesky wide to the left. Peyton Molesky slot left. Hunter Hass wide to the right. Kiefer Raisner slot to the right. Nowakin Geezy into the backfield for the Maroons. They check over that defensive front applied by Antigo. Raisner. Actually, Nathan Nowak pump big one. Zip pass over the middle. Has his man, Ethan Molesky, hauling in for the first down. He brought down immediately. Big pump big from Nowak. Then he zipped it over the middle to Ethan Molesky. And Molesky will move the chains into Antigo territory right to the 35-yard line. Quick 16-yard gain to move the chains for Menominee over the middle. So a nice pass that time. Coming up to Ethan Molesky. They'll send a receiver wide to the right, and Hunter Hass slot right with Nowak. 2 receivers to the left also. Raisner and Geezy to the backfield for Menominee. They send it at the 37-yard line. Ethan Molesky in motion from left to right. Raisner, quick pass over the middle, and it's up, and it's thrown wide to the right, and it'll drop incomplete. They'll bring up a 2nd and 10 and stop the clock with 3:29 remaining. Right here in this first half. So it was a 15-yard pass play before. Not the 16. Well, a nice play for Ethan Molesky to hold on. Giving up the Menominee Maroons now. A 2nd down and a 10 from the 37. As Kiefer Raisner's first pass of the game. Falls incomplete before. A wing on each side. Nowak has to call. Nathan Nowak wants to run up the middle and try to bounce to the outside. Makes one guy miss. Nathan Nowak to the 30. Nathan Nowak to the outside to the 25 to the 20. Nowak to the 10. 5. Touchdown, Menominee. Somehow Nathan Nowak slid out of the backfield and took it to the house. The Menominee Maroons answer again with a 37-yard touchdown run by Nathan Nowak. Nice run that time for Nathan with 3:19 remaining here in the second quarter. It'll be a 1st down and 10.
I'm sorry, first down and 10. They're going for the extra point here. And Fluke, who nearly had it blocked, but he got this one off. And it is, oh, no good. It was blocked. So the extra point was blocked, giving the Antigo Red Robin still holding on to the lead. It's 21-20. Antigo on top of Menominee back after this.
Prestige Auto Body and Truck Repair has over 25 years of experience to make your repairs fast, easy, and worry-free. With around-the-clock towing, electronic estimating, early drop-off, pickup, delivery, and the comfort of knowing Prestige Auto Body and Truck Repair is an iCar Gold Class shop, one of only 25 in the state, located on the corner of Highway 64 and 180 in Marinette. Call 715-732-4544. That's 715-732-4544 to get your estimate today. Prestige Auto Body and Truck Repair. They take the worry out of your collision repair.
Well, the Johnson Sewer Cleaning scoreboard now reads 21-20, Menominee. I'm sorry, 21-20, Antigo, after Menominee just scored on a 37-yard touchdown run by Nathan Nowak. Thor Fluke's extra point was blocked. With 3:19 to go here in this second quarter, Johnson Sewer Cleaning scoreboard, 21-20, Red Robins. Thor Fluke has it teed up at the 40. As we await Caleb Hunter to return this one, and to be one of the middlemen with a very extremely high kick ball, and then Hunter actually does get it, and Hunter's hammered down. The ball popped up, but the Red Robins jumped on it at the 41-yard line. The ball was popped out of Hunter's hands as he was stood up at the 44, but the Red Robins were right there immediately to drop on it at the 41. So first down and 10, Antigo at the 41-yard line. With 3:11 to go, let's see if the Maroon defense can hold them here. And going to halftime down by a point. Extremely high kickoff that time for Fluke. Somehow Hunter got under it. They moved him up to the middle position. He was normally a back deep as a return man. That time he was in the right spot and almost broke it. Luke Berner wide to the left side, slot left. One back in the backfield, wing in motion from left to right. They're going to hand it off to him. Trying to cut it up is Max Nowinski. And Nowinski is brought on after a gain of a couple. So Max Nowinski, the two-yard pickup. So it'll be a second down and an 8 from their own 44-yard line. That'll come to the 43-yard line is where they're going to place the ball. As head coach Tom Schofield has to play out there to his team, taking a lot of time, letting the clock tick. 2:40 remaining in the second half. And now they want to call timeout and talk something over. So a timeout down below. I want to thank a few of our participating sponsors here. Kane Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, Oconto, Marinette. Kane driving the game to you as the number one truck destination north of Green Bay. And Eckmeyer Heating and Sheet Metal at 1212 18th Avenue in Menominee, probably supporting the Menominee Maroons. Yeah, keep it here for halftime. I'll have a little rundown for you. And this week in sports from John Johnson. The MHSAA. They don't have the MHSAA perspective anymore. They replaced it with that, so we'll play that for you at halftime and, of course, in stats. Take a quick break. Back in 30.
Menards is a place to save big money on all your home improvement needs. Whether you're building or remodeling, Menards has everything you need for your home under one roof. From building materials and tools to paint, carpeting, cabinets, and all the finishing touches, you'll find quality products, helpful, friendly service, and delivery 7 days a week. And at Menards, you'll always find the lowest prices and sales, too.
Save big money at Menards.
Second down and 8 on the way for the Antigo Red Robins from their own 43-yard line. Everybody in tight. Alex Nagel will duck things down under center for the Red Robins. A wing on each side, one in motion from right to left. Spin bootlegging to the left side looks like to be an option, but the Menominee Maroons are going to be all over him as he could have possibly pitched it to Elijah Wickersham, but Wickersham is a little too close for him. He tried to cut it up, and the Maroons will snuff it out and bring him down after a gain of about 3. They're going to give him a pretty generous spot here to the 46. Now for that 3-yard gain. So a 3-yard pickup for Alex Nagel, bringing up a 3rd down and 5 from the 46. Their own 46 from the Antigo Red Robins, with 2 minutes remaining in this game. In the second quarter, that is. As the sun is down, dark skies coming in. It's starting to cool off a little bit, and it feels great. Real hot, humid day. One receiver wide to the right, another one wide to the left. Wing in motion from left to right. Alex Nagel spins a counter, wants to hand it off, and he's hit and driven nowhere. It looked like, I think it's going to be Caleb Hunter possibly, or I'm sorry, Elijah Wickersham on the carry. And he lost 2 yards. So Wickersham, nowhere to go. And it's going to be fourth down for Antigo with the timeout called now by the Menominee Maroons. And they're going to have a chance to do something here with a minute 38 remaining. Then you have a very dangerous punt return man back there showing some brightness with Ethan Molesky. He's got a fumble on a punt return already today and another fumble earlier on in the game. The Menominee Maroons have two turnovers in this one. And the defense has been on the field quite a bit this evening. It's going to be a fourth down and a 7 for the Red Robins back at their own 44. As Ethan Molesky will drop back to return this one. And the Red Robins taking a lot of time. It's another punt team out there with a minute 38 to go. 21-20 Antigo on top of Menominee. Blocked extra point on the Maroons' last touchdown. Alex Nagel to punt this one away. Caleb Hunter runs into the last second for the Red Robins. Molesky, that's Ethan Molesky back to his own 21-yard line. Nagel has it, and he'll get a foot into it, and he'll angle this one out of bounds. And this one actually hit the band. Let's see where they're going to spot it, where it went. Oh, he's going to spot it at about the 33-yard line, kicking it away from Ethan Molesky. So a 23-yard punt gives the Maroons the ball at the 33-yard line. Their own 33-yard line on the right hash with 94 seconds left and no timeouts left by Menominee. Down by a point. Hunter Hass wide to the right side. Ethan Molesky, slot left. Another receiver wide to the left. Slot right with Reisner. They have the no-walk. Back to pass. Zips it over. Has this man. It's caught by Molesky at the 40-yard line. Molesky slipped as he cut after he gained about 7 yards. Had some green grass in front of him. Maybe would have got 3 or 4 more extra yards as he tried to cut around a defender. But he slipped and fell down. Picking up about 9 yards on that pass play. So a 9-yard pass play that time from Nowak to hit Molesky. Two receivers right, two to left. Back to pass. It'll be Nowak in. Nowak zips it over the middle, and it's nearly intercepted as it went off the fingertips of a lineman who dropped back at the last second. He's a little shaken up as that ball had a lot of mustard on it, and he's hurting his fingers. He's coming off the field. As Adam Schmidt is hurting. He's hurting a lot. He's on his knees right now trying to get off the field. And he will now get off the field with that incomplete pass from Nathan Nowak. And now we have an official timeout as he did not get off the field. And now they get him off the field as the official stopped the clock. And they got to put some more time up in the clock as because with the official blew the whistles and stopped the clock because of the injury. They'll have to see what they're going to put up there. As they're going to talk some things over. And they're getting ready to tack some more time up there with a minute, 2 now remaining. 21-20. Antigo on top of Menominee. Third down and 1 for the Maroons. From the 42-yard line. Their own 42-yard line. Pass wide to the right. Reisner slot to the right. Molesky slot left. And Mitchell Boucher wide to the left. As we have Geezy and Nowak into the backfield for Menominee. And then Nowak, a couple of hard counts now for the Maroons. Nowak back to pass, bootlegging to the right side. Nathan, pump fake once, floats over to the right side. Has Reisner, Reisner to the 45 or the 40, steps out of bounds. Nice job for keeper Reisner to the 35-yard line. A little pump fake from Nowak, then Reisner went the other way. Downfield, and he hauled in a gorgeous pass from Nathan Nowak to move the chains for the Maroons. All the way to the 36-yard line. On that 31-yard pass for the Maroons from Nowak to Reisner. Two receivers left, two to the right side of the 36-yard line. Nathan Nowak back to pass again, zips at the center of the field, and it's off, and it's intercepted for the third turnover of the game. To the 40, 45-yard line to the 50, and Nowak is going to try to bring him down, and he does to the 35-yard line. The linebacker just dropped back and read the eyes of Nathan Nowak. He threw it, he tipped it to himself. And now with 44 seconds to go, the Red Robins have a chance to put some more points on the board. Three turnovers in the first half by Menominee have killed them in this contest so far. And the big interception there. So first down and 10 on the way now for the Enigo Red Robins at the 36-yard line. Now first down and 10, wing to the left, split back to the backfield, a double handoff, and bounce into the center of the field, then hit and then brought down as they give it to Max Nowinski on a double handoff. And the Red Robins will call a timeout with 35 seconds remaining. Short gain of a yard by Nowinski. Actually, give him a gain of two for Max Nowinski. So a two-yard pickup for Max Nowinski. Timeout down on the field. Hey, visit North Motorsports, the area's only full-line dealer of Honda, Can-Am, Ski-Doo, Sea-Doo, and Snapper outdoor products. From their friendly sales staff to their certified service technicians, they've got you covered. Visit North Motorsports at 3711 10th Street in Menominee or give them a call at 906-863-5592. Kane, yep, Kane, driving the game to you as the number one truck destination north of Green Bay. Kane, Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, Oconto, and Marinette. And Ekmeyer Heating and Sheet Metal at 1212 18th Avenue in Menominee, they probably support the Maroons. Well, that Johnson Sewer Cleaning scoreboard reads 35.6 seconds remaining in the second quarter. It's 21-20 Antigo. And they'll have a second down and eight on the 34-yard line in Menominee territory. Three turnovers in the game for Menominee so far. And that's really hurt them. Everyone in tight. Nagel back to pass, bootlegging to the right side. Has his man out there, pump big once, airs it on. It's up and it is incomplete, batted down. Good defense that time for the Maroons.
Nagel pass attempted for Kirsch.
Yes, that was intended for Hunter Kirsch. And then I'll stop the clock with 29 seconds remaining. So Alex Nagel throws that one incomplete. As Kirsch and Molesky and another Marooner there fighting for it. And Molesky came and batted that one to the ground. So third down and eight at the Maroon 34-yard line for the Antigo Red Robins. They'll send a receiver wide to the left side, coming my way, and that is Luke Berner. Slot left for Hunter. Wing on the left as well. Alex Nagel back to pass, ruling on the left side. Blitz homes, they bring him down. They get to a big sack in the backfield. Justin Castor for Menominee. And they may just let the clock tick down as this one's back to the 41-yard line. 13 seconds to go. Make it 10. It's a 5-yard sack.
Sacks on the play. There's a fourth down, timeout.
Timeout called by Lubanigo Red Robins. So a 5-yard loss on that sack by Castor. And as Alex Nagel, 9 carries now for 80 yards. It's fourth down. Actually, the Maroons had one more timeout left, so they must have called timeout with being a fourth down. In the 15 to the 41-yard line. The Red Robins have it on the Maroon 41. The Maroons down by a point, 21-20, as we're getting ready to head into halftime. Key with the air bubble this week in the MHSAA from John Johnson. I'll give you a scoring summary and a rundown of all the stats. All at halftime. Fourth down and eight from the 41-yard line. Alex Nagel dropped back to pass. Wants to float it right side of the field. It's up and it is caught. The flag flying to the 10-yard line. The clock will stop with 2.6 seconds to go.
Nagel pass complete the winter.
I believe this is going to be an incomplete or a penalty on the Maroons. With 2.6 seconds to go, they get down and they can take one shot at it here. Pass interference on Menominee. It was fourth down and a 14. And they just floated it up left side of the field. Pass interference on the Maroons and a big one. They decline it.
Pass interference on Menominee declined.
With 2.6 seconds to go. First down at the Red Robins. They don't have the ball placed yet.
What yard line is the ball on? You tell us.
And Alex Nagel's going to take the snap and then throw it down to the ground. And they'll stop the clock with 0.2 seconds to go. As the ball is on the... looks like the 11 or the 12-yard line. They might put a half a second up in the clock with 0.2 seconds remaining. It'll be a second down as he downed the ball, Alex Nagel did. So 21-20 right now, 1-point lead for the Antigo Red Robins. And they're trying to get the scoreboard set here. It was a 29-yard pass for the Red Robins to get the first down. As the Red Robins, the last play of the game with 1.4 seconds left. The officials are going to go on with going to be the last play of the quarter, or of the half, I should say. And it'll be a first down and a goal. And under center will be Alex Nagel. Nagel, back to pass, rolling to the right side. Has a man wide open in the back of the end zone. Now he'll find him, he'll float it up there, and it's out of the back of the end zone. Well out, incomplete, and that will end the first half. So the Maroons get lucky in the end, and they're lucky to go into the halftime down by a point with three turnovers. 21-20. We are the Antigo Red Robins on top of the Menominee Maroons. Back after this in your Bay City's radio dial.
Let me tell you, Advanced Motors, located in Coleman, has AMSOIL for all your motorcycle, ATV, marine, and vehicle needs. AMSOIL, the first in synthetics. Are you or your student moving? Advanced Motors, a U-Haul dealer, also carries packing and moving supplies for all your needs. Stop in or call today at 920-897-2677. That's 920-897-2677. That's right.
Peshtigo National Bank, your locally owned independent community bank, supports all local high school sports. Since opening in 1901, they've grown to five locations in Peshtigo, Coleman, Oconto Falls, Gillette, and Marinette. Hometown banking with your neighbors and friends, Peshtigo National Bank has proudly served the community for over 100 years. Locally owned community banks support and help fund local projects. Keep your banking local and speak with a representative today. Good luck to all area high school teams from Peshtigo National Bank, member FDIC.
Menza & Zach, your local Tempstar dealer. Experts in heating, cooling, and sheet metal. Fully insured in Michigan and Wisconsin for your residential, commercial, and light industrial needs. Serving all brands, installation in new construction and remodels, along with preventative furnace and air conditioner maintenance. 24-hour emergency service available. Check out their website to see a full list of services offered at MenzaAndZach.com. Located at 60 Water Street in Marinette.
Hi, this is Paul, CEO of the Menominee County Federal Credit Union. We're proud to sponsor high school sports on Bay Cities Radio, and we encourage all of you to support high school athletics as well. We know there's no better way for our young people to learn the lessons of life than by competing in sports. The Menominee County Federal Credit Union, where you dream the dream, will help make it come true, with locations in Powers, Kearney, Stevenson, and Menominee. Persons living or working in Marinette and Menominee counties are eligible for membership.
Find your next truck at Kane, the number one truck destination north of Green Bay for 2015. From the most dependable full-size pickups on the road, Kane delivers Silverado. Or the most advanced pickup ever, Kane delivers Sierra. Right now, visit Kane in Marinette or Oconto to enter the Chevrolet Packers Ultimate Fan Sweepstakes. Win a 2016 Chevrolet and other great prizes. Over 300 quality vehicles at KaneGM.com, Oconto, and Marinette.
Bayside Motorsports and Cycle is your full-line service destination, servicing most makes and models of ATVs and motorcycles, from a simple tune-up and oil change to major engine overhauls. Their expanded service department will have you back on your machines fast. Bayside Motorsports and Cycle also specializes in motorcycle and ATV performance work to keep you a step above your competition. Ask about their service specials. Bayside Motorsports and Cycle in Green Bay or at BaysideMotorsports.com.
Go west on 180 at the Holiday. Save on cars and trucks every day. You're sure to save a bubble when you take that drive. West on 180 to the Riverside. You get to the roundabout, make sure you yield. Don't go straight, cause it's all cornfields. Just turn left when you see that sign. Come on in to the Riverside. We'll find what you're looking for. Just show up at our front door. Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram trucks. No overhead seats, you big bucks. Come take a ride, if you dare. Out with the cows in the country air. Save big money on your next ride. When you see your friends at Riverside. From the West Big 64 until you get to our front door in Marinette. You sure to save a bundle when you take that drive. One way or another gets you Riverside. One way or another gets you Riverside.
Well, it's halftime right here in your hometown radio station, 103.7 FM, WHYB, Menominee and Marinette, and BayCitiesOnline.com. I'm Josh Kellner. Glad you could join me here this evening from Schofield Stadium in Antigo, Wisconsin. The Antigo Red Robins on top of the Menominee Maroons by a point, 21-20 here at the half. The difference in the ballgame is a blocked extra point attempt on the Maroons' last score at the 3:19 mark. Let you know how we got here. We'll start off first with Antigo Red Robins. How do they get there? 21 points. Well, 9 carries for 80 yards for their quarterback Alex Nagel, including 2 touchdowns. Max Nowinski has 7 carries for 11 yards. Wilt Dixon, 5 carries for 7 yards. Caleb Hunter had 2 carries for a yard. And Elijah Wakersheim, 1 carry for negative 2 yards. Alex Nagel passing is 4 of 9 through the air with 1 touchdown and 110 yards. A 60-yard touchdown pass to Elijah Wakersheim, who's got 2 catches for 89 yards. Then Will Dixon has 2 catches for 21 yards on the screen pass. As they ran 36 plays and 216 yards of total offense. So that's 110 yards through the air, 106 yards on the ground for the Antigo Red Robins. The big one, though, no turnovers. Let's take a look at Menominee Maroons. As they have more yardage than the Red Robins. They ran 28 plays for 231 yards of total offense. 90 passing yards for the Menominee Maroons. And 141 rushing yards for Menominee. But 3 turnovers. 2 fumbles and 1 interception. One of the fumbles was on a punt return. So leading the way for Menominee, Nathan Nowak, 7 carries for 99 yards and a touchdown. And a nice 37-yard touchdown run. Kiefer Reisner, 7 carries for 41 yards. Zach Giese, 4 carries for 11 yards and a touchdown. Nathan Nowak passing. He's 5 of 9 for 90 yards, 1 touchdown and 1 interception. Tanner Mathias has 2 catches for 35 yards and a touchdown. Ethan Molesky has 2 catches for 24 yards. And Kiefer Reisner has 1 catch for 31 yards. And the 3 turnovers really hurt Menominee in this first half, as they're down by a point. 3 turnovers and a block extra point. All right, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll come back with This Week in Michigan, or This Week in High School Sports from the MHSAA's John Johnson. So keep it right here on your Bay Cities radio dial.
Glass of Menominee has over 100 years of experience in the glass business. Visit the glazing contractors at Essers for all your glass needs, such as general glass replacement in windows and frames, custom mirrors, insulated glass units, screen replacement, or frameless glass shower doors. Esser Glass is proud to be a Menominee Maroon sponsor in the community. Esser Glass at 821 7th Street in Menominee. Maroons, have a great season and good luck.
Looking for a credit union that truly cares about you and the community you live in? Then you ought to stop and see the folks at Bayshore Credit Union. Membership is open to anyone living or working in Marinette, Menominee, and Oconto counties. Whether it's everyday banking, a new auto loan, new mortgage, even a consolidation loan, they can help. And it's never too early to start establishing good credit. Bayshore Credit Union, located at 1514 Cleveland Avenue, Marinette, they're looking forward to meeting you.
Life insurance is one of those subjects that makes people want to change the subject rather than admit they probably don't have enough. That's why State Farm agent Tony Furton focuses on how benefits of life insurance actually live on by asking people to think in terms of life without having to sell the house insurance or life without having to give up college insurance. Find out how the benefits of life insurance can live on for your family. Call State Farm agent Tony Furton in Menominee at 906-863-4464 and put the life back in life insurance. Prestige Auto Body and Truck Repair has over 25 years of experience to make your repairs fast, easy, and worry-free. With around-the-clock towing, electronic estimating, early drop-off, pickup, delivery, and the comfort of knowing Prestige Auto Body and Truck Repair is an iCar gold-class shop, one of only 25 in the state, located on the corner of Highway 64 and 180 in Marinette. Call 715-732-4544. That's 715-732-4544 to get your estimate today. Prestige Auto Body and Truck Repair. They take the worry out of your collision repair.
Eagles bowl over the Bays, taking Spearing out of the game and saying goodbye to a few good men. It's all next on This Week in High School Sports, presented by the Amber Alert Foundation. Hi again, everyone. I'm John Johnson, and welcome to This Week in High School Sports. It's called the Weather Bowl whenever Engadine and Brimley get together on the gridiron because it's usually played in some of the worst weather of the season, usually in the 8th or the 9th week. But the Weather Bowl was an opening night matchup this year in Engadine where the Eagles continued their winning ways against the Bays in a 58-26 non-conference 8-player football win. Junior quarterback Trevor Brawley passed for 221 yards to lead the offense, and after the game, he and teammate Hunter Collins spoke about winning on their home field to MHSAA network affiliate Radio Eagle in Newberry.
It felt amazing. This is our home turf. Last year, we went undefeated at home. We want to keep this season going.
The crowd was ecstatic. I love the crowd here. You always get good support here at Engadine.
Absolutely unbelievable. It felt fantastic to bring this home for my team.
Engadine opens Western UP 8-man conference play this week against Powers North Central. And now let's give out some this week game balls. Kamenu Gwili, Utica's senior running back, rushed for 392 yards on 27 carries and scored 6 touchdowns, leading the Chieftains to a 41-31 win over Frazier in a Macomb Area Conference crossover victory. 5 of those scores came in the first half. Don Watala, our old friend in Traverse City, began his 50th year of broadcasting high school football games last week. After years of owning his own station in the area, he's now the play-by-play voice of Traverse City St. Francis on WLJN. And to the good folks in Mount Pleasant, a game ball for the great community effort to improve Community Memorial Stadium. Originally built as a citywide project 50 years ago to become the home for the Mount Pleasant High and Sacred Heart Academy football teams, the improvements included a field turf installation and a beautiful Pillars of the Community entrance. You can read all about the effort in Jeff Kimmerly's second half piece on the MHSAA website this week. Back with more in a moment. You're listening to This Week in High School Sports.
Do you love me?
When a child is abducted, the first 24 hours is critical. The Michigan Amber Alert Program helps get the word out fast, and that can make all the difference.
Will you care for me?
All you have to do to help is check the box on your state income tax form to make a small donation that could save a child's life.
Will you help? Check the box.
This message is sponsored by the Michigan Amber Alert Foundation and the Michigan Association of Broadcasters.
Our weekly Be the Referee segment will help you better understand the fine art of officiating with Mark Ewell.
One of the new changes to the high school football rules for this year is an expanded definition of spearing an opponent with the helmet. With all the attention on player safety and reducing the head-to-head collisions between players, this new definition of illegal helmet contact will better help officials, coaches, players, and fans realize what is illegal and what must be penalized by rule. Simply put, a spearing foul has taken place when a player hits an opponent with the crown or top portion of his helmet as that first point of contact. These fouls where contact has been initiated by a player first with the crown of the helmet must be called and enforced consistently throughout the season.
Thanks, Mark. You can be a referee. Go online now to MHSAA.com to register. As I walked along the fence line at a football game at my local school last week, there was a noticeable gap where Al Inkela, who coached Okemos to 4 straight Lower Peninsula girls tennis titles, usually watched. Inkela, who was a five-sport, that's right, five-sport standout at Wakefield High School in the Western Upper Peninsula back in the 60s, was one of three notable teacher coaches who passed from this life over the summer. Shortly after Inkela's passing, word came from Cadillac that Jeff McDonald, who had won over 300 games in 20 years of coaching basketball and 30 years of teaching, had lost his battle with pancreatic cancer. And it wasn't but a week after that that we learned that former Fremont track and cross-country coach Rich Tompkins had died of a heart attack. After leading his teams to six MHSAA cross-country titles and retiring from coaching, Rich headed up the Michigan High School Coaches Association. What was impressive about all of these gentlemen was that they not only won titles, but that they won the hearts and the minds of those around them, teaching young people, because that's what coaches, especially school sports coaches, are, teachers. Builders, people laying a foundation for life for the kids. And that's what Al Inkela, Jeff McDonald, and Rich Tompkins did so very well, and they'll be missed. You've been listening to This Week in High School Sports, presented by the Amber Alert Foundation, a production of the MHSAA Network. Thanks for listening, everyone. I'm John Johnson. We'll see you next time.
Stop in at Colonel K's Pasties to get a taste of the UP. Choose from their large variety of delicious homemade pasties, fresh or frozen, homemade soups made daily, coffee of the day, and their amazing soft serve ice cream. Make Colonel K's your breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Dine in, pick up, or drive through. You can't go wrong when you choose Colonel K's. Colonel K's Pasties, located on 10th Street in Menominee. The friendly food shaped like a smile. Stop in and pick up or drive through today.
Farmers and Merchants Bank and Trust offers a variety of loan programs, vehicle loans, personal loans, and commercial loans. They do real estate mortgages, offer home equity options, and work with government loan programs. Farmers and Merchants Bank and Trust is here to serve you in three locations, Ludington Street in Marinette, Roosevelt Road in Marinette, and Highway 141 in Crivitz. They can show you how to make your banking life easier, save you time, and save you money. Contact them today. Farmers and Merchants Bank and Trust, member FDIC.
Well, back at it right here on your hometown radio station, 103.7 FM, WHYB, Menominee and Marinette, and BayCitiesOnline.com. I am Josh Kellner. Glad you're with me this evening from Schofield Stadium in Antigo. The Antigo Red Robins are on top of the Menominee Maroons by a point, 21-20. That difference is a blocked extra point on the Maroons' last score, closing off the first half. That was at about the 3:19 mark. After Nathan Nowak, 37-yard touchdown run. Yeah, Antigo, 216 yards of total offense, while the Menominee Maroons, 231 yards of total offense, but three turnovers is the story of the half for Menominee, with two fumbles and an interception, really setting up the Red Robins. Definitely one of them was set up the Red Robins for a touchdown. It was a punt return that was fumbled out in the first quarter. And again, if you missed it, the Menominee Maroon Junior Varsity team played before this contest, so a doubleheader of football, with the Menominee Maroon JVs losing to the Red Robins. 48-38 was the final score there. Looking at the Junior Varsity match, but I don't know about the Red Robins, if you're familiar with the Menominee Maroon JVs, only six sophomores on that team. There's no freshman team in Menominee this year. Again, as a lot of the players are freshmen on the Junior Varsity squad. Well, the Antigo Red Robins received to open up the contest, so that means Menominee will open up to begin the second half. As we have a couple minutes until the start of the second half right here in your Bay Cities radio dial. Yeah, using a new setup to dial back to the studio these days. We got new equipment. We have an app that we use. Just plug in our iPhone and we hit a button and then it automatically connects to the computer back in the studio and it sounds crystal clear. So we don't have to worry about using the phone line and you get that tingy sound. If you hear like that tingy sound, like it sounds like we're talking over a phone line, that means we have technical difficulties and there wasn't enough 4G or 3G or a chance to get any Wi-Fi where we actually had to use the normal cell phone connection. So we're getting a lot of comments about that, how it sounds crystal clear, and it's coming through pretty good. So hopefully, my broadcast has to be a little bit more clear. I can't blame it on the phone line as much as I used to. So I'll try to work best play-by-play that I can bring you here in Menominee this evening. Well, in Antigua, but back at home in Menominee this evening. We go from the old-school Marty unit when I was back at home. I like to use that big box with the antenna, the glorified CB unit, but couldn't talk back. The station couldn't talk back to me, but I'd talk back to the station. So home games always sounded good. And then on the road games, we always would use a cell phone, or I'd try to use a normal phone line connection when it was available. And the quality just wasn't there. But now it's all shaped up, and sounds pretty good. And if you're looking for a way to catch the broadcast, of course, on the radio, 103.7 FM on your hometown radio dial. If you're sitting at a computer or your desktop or even your tablet or your phone, you can click BayCitiesOnline.com. Then just go to the WHYB link. You can click on that on the WHYB page and, you know, listen live or the live sports link. It'll bring you right there. Or an easier way, if you have a smartphone or a tablet, just download the app. Go to your Apple Store or whatever phone service you have and type in 103.7 FM, WHYB, Hometown Radio, anything along that line, and the app will pull up. You know, you can download that. Just click a button, and it'll take you right to whatever's being broadcasted. Right now, it'll be Menominee Marine Sports. It's the easiest way to do things, and if you're wondering what that app looks like, just follow me on Twitter, at Maroons Radio. Pretty simple, and I always post the link to the app or a picture of the app, and you can download it from there. You can go from there, and of course, you'll get inside information from me as well when I have a chance to blow up Twitter and head out your way. But halftime here, 21-20, the Antigo Red Robins on top of the Menominee Maroons by a point. I'm going to take one more quick break. When I come back, we'll have the beginning of your second half after this quick 30.
Where can you go to get a bite to eat before or after the game? Dexter's. Dexter's in Menominee has enough seating for the whole team and a menu to fit everyone's taste and appetite. Or call ahead and take your order to go. Dexter's looks forward to seeing you this year. Good luck to all M&M Sports participants. Dexter's, located on 10th Avenue in Menominee. Check out their menu online at DextersRestaurantOnline.com and like us on Facebook.
Again, halftime score 21-20 in favor of the Antigo Red Robins over the Menominee Maroons. Well, a game that took place in a rare Thursday afternoon contest. I think this was at 12:30 or 1:30. Kingster played down in DeWitt, and DeWitt defeated the Flivers 38-7. That's one to pay attention to because Menominee obviously will play Kingsford on September 25th as the game time for that. But then the Maroons' homecoming game will be against DeWitt on October 16th, week 8, second to last game of the regular season. And DeWitt, Division 3 powerhouse, will come up to Menominee to take on the Maroons. Escanaba is in Petoskey tonight. Gladstone is at the Superior Dome taking on Benzie Central, and Marquette is hosting Traverse City Central. So there's some Great Northern Conference games of interest to you coming up this evening, and of course a Flipper game yesterday. The Red Robins 2-0 coming into this contest, wins over Two Rivers and Oconto. They shut out Oconto last week 35-0. They put up 40 on Two Rivers in week one. Well, the Menominee Maroons back on the field ready to return the kickoff to begin the second half. Again, they are in their road white jerseys, maroon pants, white hats. Well, the Red Robins, they're like maroon jerseys with silver white pants. And then the maroon hats with, the Red Robins, the feathers, we'll say, on the sides of their helmets in silver. Well, Hunter Hass and Mitchell Boucher back to return this one for Menominee. Let's see if they switch. Hunter Hass will be on my side, and Boucher will go on the other side, with Menominee going right to left on your Bay Cities radio dial. That is west to east here in Antigo from the concession stand of the scoreboard here at Schofield Stadium. As Mitchell Wagner will drop back deep to kick this one off, awaiting the whistle to begin this second half with Menominee down by a point. And he'll get a foot into it. Line drive kick, bouncing and rolling. Hass on the run at the 25-yard line to the 30. Hunter Hass to the 40, spinning his way forward and brought down at the 45-yard line. That nice little seam of Hunter Hass using his speed to bring it up to the 45-yard line, and that's where the Menominee Maroons will begin this second half. Let's see the adjustments that they're going to make. Actually, they're going to give him the 46. Oh, they put the ball back to the 45. As they have the Antigo ball placed in the 46, and they put the maroon ball out there. It goes to the 45. They just adjusted it to get the right pigskin out there. Wing formation to the right and to the left. Nathan Nowak rolls to the right side, looking to pass that. He'll tuck it and run, and Nowak will dive his way to the 49-yard line to gain about 4 yards, just shy of that 50. So a 4-yard pickup, he'll cut it up on the right side for the Maroons. And that gives Nathan over the century yard mark, the 103 yards on 8 carries for Nathan. And it'll be a 2nd and 6 now for Menominee from the right hash on their own 49. A wing to the right and a wing to the left. Razor in at tailback now. Up the middle, Zach Giese. Giese plowing his way forward, spinning his way, trying to get some extra yardage, and he does into Antigo territory at about the 47, maybe the 48-yard line, depending on where they're going to spot the ball. Zach Giese is only his 5th carry of the game. They're looking to place it actually on Antigo 49-yard line. It's only a 2-yard pickup that time for Giese. As Zach Giese had 150 yards and one half a play against Marinette last week. Tonight, 13 yards. Third down and 4 now for the Maroons. The right hash of the Antigo 49. Everybody in tight. Off the middle, Nathan Nowak. Nowak has a first down, and he slips as he tries to cut at the 40-yard line. They might spot him at the 41, but a nice, fast run that time for Nathan Nowak with Zach Giese leading the way blocking. And they'll spot it at the 41. He slipped and fell down and slid his way forward, so his knee did hit at the 41. So an 8-yard gain that time for Nathan Nowak, and the Maroons get a first down. So first down and 10 now for Menominee. Still on that right hash from the 41-yard line. 30 seconds in, or a minute and a half in to this second half. 21-20, one-point lead for the Red Robins. Nowak will hand it off to Molesky. That's actually Keeper Razor. Razor trying to get to the outside. And Razor gets a yard, maybe two, trying to go wide. Instead of Keeper following the blockers and cutting it up, he tries to go around them. And when he does that, he actually loses a few yards. He doesn't lose, but he doesn't get as much as he could possibly get. It is a 2-yard pickup trying to go around that left side at about the 39-yard line for Keeper Razor. Well, the junior running back getting a short yardage there. Second and 8, under 10 minutes remaining in this third quarter. Hunter Haas wide to the right side. Slot right, Keeper Razor. Ethan Molesky slot left. And wide to the left side will be Peyton Molesky. Nowak and Giese into the backfield. Nowak wants to run, trying to bounce to the outside. Now trying to break a stiff arm. He breaks a tackle, spinning his way, pushing his way forward is Nathan Nowak. And the whistles will be blown at about the 37-yard line. Nowak hit for a loss, but managed to shed off that first tackler and get some positive yards.
Third down.
As they'll spot it at about the 37-yard line for a 2-yard pickup. So a 2-yard gain for Nathan Nowak, and it could have been nothing. And the Maroons will face a third down and 6. 9:13 here in this third quarter. The Maroons down by a point. First series of the half for either team. Razor wing to the right, Molesky wing to the left. Giese and Nowak into the backfield. 7 players in the box now for the Red Hornets. Back to pass. Nowak. Nowak dips it center of the field. Has the man out there. It's in and out of the hands and nearly intercepted. Would have been an easy 6 points for Mitchell Boucher. Check that, Spencer Howell, but Howell took his eyes off the ball, bobbled it, and popped up, and it nearly fell into the hands of a Red Robin. A great pass for Noah, but another drop pass by a Menominee Maroon receiver. And the Maroons now face a 4th down and a 6.
4th and 6 for the Maroons.
Still at the Antigo 37-yard line. Stop. The clock stops with 8:53 to go. And Raisner will be a wing to the right, Molesky a wing to the left. Giese and Nowak into the backfield. As they're trying to get the Red Robin fans into this one, it'll be in a 4th down. Nowak, back to pass, looks right, now cuts to the left side. No one is there. Miscommunication there. Looked like they wanted to have a screen pass to the left, and nobody was there on Nowak's pass. And the Maroons will turn it over on downs. So back-to-back incomplete passes, one a drop pass. And with 8:49 to go, the Red Robins offense will head onto the field at their own 37-yard line. So let's see what the Red Robins did for adjustments at halftime with their first offensive series from their own 37. Ball placed center of the field. Away on the left, split backs in backfield behind Alex Nagel. Nagel spins, hands off first back throughout the middle, big hole and hit hard as it collapsed the 40-yard line. As Ethan Molesky came up and put a big hit that time on Will Dixon for a gain of 4. So a 4-yard gain for Will Dixon. Bring up a 2nd down and 6 to the 41-yard line. So Red Robins will break huddle. Caleb Hunter wide to the left side. 2nd down and 6 from their own 41-yard line. 3 backs in the backfield. Nagel spins, takes hand off the option to the right. Now he cuts it up center of the field. He's hitting and brought down. I don't know if he got to the line of scrimmage. It's going to be really close. He might have got there, might have got a half a yard. We'll have to wait and see what the official call is. No gain. We'll keep it at third down and at six for Alex Nagel's run. So third down and six, with under 8 minutes remaining in this third quarter. Again, 1 point lead for the Red Robins. Wide to the right side, they'll send Luke Berner. With a wing on the right also in Caleb Hunter. Wing on the left as well, one back in the backfield. That's going to be Will Dixon behind Nagel. Wing and Moise from left to right. They give to Dixon. Actually fake the handoff, back to pass. The screen set up again, and it's up, and it hits the back of the Menominee Maroon, and a flag will fly the pass interference. Late play as the official was trying to dig for it. And the person covering Dixon never looked at the ball, just kept pushing him out of the way. Easy call on the far side for the official. This will be a penalty on the Maroons. Missed the Maroon number that was in coverage. Well, this will be a first down for the Red Robins. The ball was on their own 41-yard line. This is going to go all the way into Menominee territory to the 44-yard line. And that 15-yard penalty. The Maroons' first penalty of the game. Actually, I'm sorry, second penalty of the game. The first one was waved off. It was also a pass interference penalty to close off the second quarter. So first down and 10 for the Red Robins on the Menominee 44-yard line. A wing on the right. Now the end will go down with split backs coming up behind Alex Nagel and head coach Tom Schofield. Sees some miscommunication down below and calls a timeout. So timeout down below, 7:26 to go, third quarter. It is Antigo 21, Menominee 20, back after this.
One of those subjects that make people want to change the subject. I'm State Farm Agent Brent Merritt, and that's why I focus on how the benefits of life insurance actually live on, by asking people to think in terms of life without having to sell the house insurance, or life without having to give up college insurance. Find out how the benefits of life insurance can live on for your family. Contact me, State Farm Agent Brent Merritt, serving Wisconsin and Michigan.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Well, visit North Motorsports, the area's only full-line dealer of Honda, Can-Am, Ski-Doo, Sea-Doo, and Snapper outdoor products. And from their friendly sales staff to their certified service technicians, they've got you covered. Visit North Motorsports at 3711 10th Street, Menominee, or give them a call at 906-863-5592. That's North Motorsports in Menominee. After the timeout called by head coach Tom Schofield of Antigo, the Red Robins have a first down and 10 again at the Menominee 44-yard line. Wing on the right, split back to the backfield behind Nagel. Nagel, quarterback keeper, trying to go wide to the left. The Maroons will snuff it out after Nagel gains about 3, maybe 4 yards.
Nagel on a carry.
On a good fake. That time to Max Nowinski. He'll gain 3 yards. It'll be a second down and a 7. So a 3 yard gain that time for Alex Nagel. 11 carries, 83 yards, and 2 touchdowns for the Red Robin quarterback. As they spot this one at the Menominee 41. 6:55 to go, third quarter, 1 point Red Robin lead. Three backs in the backfield behind Nagel. He'll set things down under center. Nagel spins, hands off, up the middle, big hole to the right. Then the hole is collapsed with Ethan Leskey coming up and leading the way. And trying to get some running there was Max Nowinski. Nowinski maybe got a couple into Menominee territory to the 39-yard line. They'll give him a gain of 2.
Nowinski on the carry, tackled by Nowinski.
So a 2 yard run that time for Nowinski. Ethan Molesky and Nathan Nowak on the tackle. It'll be a third down and 5. 6:22 and taking third quarter. This is at the Menominee 39-yard line. It's the Maroon defense trying to stiffen here and get the ball back, put the offense back on the field. As the Red Robins will break huddle. Luke Berner now wide left side. They have to get this ball off as the clock is ticking. Wing on the left, wing on the right, one back in the backfield. Man in motion, right to left. Delay of game violation, the flags fly. See, that was a fast count. They weren't going to fall off anytime soon anyway, so they just put a man in motion. So this will put them back 5 yards. Their third penalty of the game for 15. Instead of it being a third down and 5, it's now going to be the third and 10. Back to the 44. So third down now for the Red Robins, third and 10 with 6 minutes remaining. 6:02 to be exact in this third quarter. Wide to the right side, Luke Berner. Alex Nagel takes his team up to the ball. A wing on the right side of Caleb Hunter. Nowinski's a wing on the left. Will Dixon All alone in the backfield. Nagel back to pass. Pressure now coming from all angles. Matthias trying to catch him. Can't do so. High pass. It sails out of bounds. Giese nearly had him as well. Matthias missed him. And Giese was chasing from the blind side. And Nowinski was the intended target. Actually, Caleb Hunter was the intended target. And Alex Nagel's pass sails well out of bounds.
Fourth down.
This will bring up a fourth down and 10 for the Red Robins. At the maroon 44-yard line, Ethan Molesky will drop back to return this one. Alex Nagel, the quarterback, is also the punter for the Red Robins.
Molesky, deep for...
And Molesky is back at his own 11-yard line right now. High snap, he'll haul it down. And Nagel gets a line drive kick on it, angling it away from Molesky. And this one never even landed in bounds. It'll sail out of bounds at the 20-yard line. 20 or the 19. Depending on the spot, let's say they'll give it the 19. Line drive kick directly out of bounds. As a punt, will give the Maroons the ball back with 5:49 remaining here in this third quarter. So let's see if the Maroon offense can roll and get the lead back.
Nagel's kick out of bounds.
As they turn the ball over on downs, their first possession here in the second half. Again, three turnovers in the first half really hampered Menominee in this contest. From the left hash, again, still going right to left in your Bay Cities radio dial, the Maroons will have things. Raisner, a wing to the right. Molesky, a wing to the left. Nowak and Giese into the backfield for Menominee. Giese goes down to the three-point. Nowak sits up standing. The snap to Nowak. Nathan cuts it up. Now he'll dive his way across the 25-yard line for a nice little run. So Nowak gains about 6 yards for the Maroons. For 8 to the 25. With Zach Giese leading the way blocking.
On the carry, picks up about 6.
So this will be a second down and a 4 now for Menominee.
For the Maroons.
From the right hash, at their own 25-yard line. Molesky wing to the left, Nowak wing to the right. Actually, Nowak is in the tailback. It was Razor wing to the right. Nowak gets a call, trying to go off left tackle again with Giese leading the way, and he's brought down to the 28-yard line.
Nowak.
So gain of about 3.
On the carry, thing about down by Smith. And
for Nowak, giving the Maroons a third down and short. There's a nice Maroon student section on the far side of the field, cheering on their Menominee Maroons. Third down and 1 for Menominee. Everybody in tight. Giese and Nowak into the backfield for Menominee. Zach Giese has called. First down and more for Zach Giese as he crosses the 30, and he'll take it to about the 33. They might give him the 34, depending on the spot. Actually, it looks like it will be the 33. So a 5-yard pickup for Zach Giese to move the chains for the Maroons.
Tackled by Jansen for the Robins.
So Zach Giese now 6 carries, 18 yards for Menominee. As the Red Robins have held him in check. When the Bruins need that short first down, though, they give it to Zach. First down and 10 from their own 33-yard line for Menominee on the left hash. Wing on the left and a wing on the right. Nowak has a call again. Nowak's going to pass and he'll tuck it and run. Nathan will streak his way forward and be pushed forward as he crosses the 35 to the 36-yard line. About a 3-yard pickup again for Nathan Nowak.
On the play.
Short yardage for Menominee.
Second and 7 for the Maroons.
125 yards on 13 carries now for Nowak in the game. Second and 7. 3:55 to go, third quarter, 21-20. Red Robins on top by a point. And Menominee will break huddle. Sam Larson, a wing to the right. Molesky, a wing to the left. Nowak and Giese into the backfield. Couple of hard counts for Norak. Low snap. He'll hand it off to Giese. Zach Giese trying to bounce the outside. He does. Zach Giese to the 40. Giese to the 45 across midfield. Zach Giese brought down from behind. They had the angle on him. At the 40-yard line in Anago territory, and Matt Winter will catch him. But a nice run for Zach Giese as he bounces to the outside all the way to the Anago 40. A gain of 24 yards for Zach Giese. Zach's yardiest run of the game. That gain there was more than all of his previous yardage combined. Two receivers to the right, two to the left now for the Maroons. Nathan Nowak wants to run at the middle. Big hole for Nowak. Nowak to the 35 to the 30. Nathan Nowak looking for a blocker to the 25 to the 20. Cuts it up now to the 15. Breaks another tackle. Nathan Nowak to the 10. Nathan Nowak to the 5. He'll dive in. Is he there? Touchdown, Menominee!
A 40-yard touchdown run by Nathan Nowak, and that was all Nathan being patient and using his skills to bring the ball into the end zone.
We have an injured Red Robin in the end zone, and it looks like he may be cramping up a little bit, trying to catch Nathan Nowak. With 3:15 remaining here in the third quarter, the Maroons strike and take the lead after the 40-yard touchdown run by Nowak. He zigzagged a lot of the field. Ran probably about 70 yards for the 40-yard touchdown. As you await to see if the Maroons will go for two here or not, with an extra point blocked before. So Nowak gets his second rushing touchdown of the game. Third touchdown total. He threw for one in the first half as well. With 3:15 remaining here in this third quarter. As injured Red Robin will walk off underneath his own power. I think the injured Red Robin is actually Alex Nagel, their quarterback. It's a little slow walking off, but looks like he's fine. And the Maroons will go for two here. Hunter Haas wide to the right. Slot right with Nowak. Reisner and Giesing to the backfield. Leski slot left. Larson wide to the left side. Down to the three-point stance. Reisner sets things. Molesky in motion from left to right. The snap to Reisner. Reisner trying to go wide. He'll cut up now. Keeper lowers the shoulder, pushing the pile forward. Still pushing. Is he there? He is with a two-point conversion. Keeper Reisner's second effort gets a two-point to get the Maroons now a seven-point lead. With a big run there, 28-21, and now the score, Menominee. We'll be back after this with a quick break in your Bay City's radio dial.
Esser Glass of Menominee has over 100 years of experience in the glass business. Visit the glazing contractors at Esser's for all your glass needs, such as general glass replacement in windows and frames, custom mirrors, insulated glass units, screen replacement, or frameless glass shower doors. Esser Glass is proud to be a Menominee Maroon sponsor in the community. Esser Glass at 821 7th Street in Menominee. Maroons, have a great season and good luck.
After the 40-yard touchdown run by Nathan Nowak, Kiefer Reisner's two-point conversion is good to give the Maroons now a seven-point lead. 3:15 remaining in the third quarter. It's 28-21 Menominee, according to that Johnson Sewer Cleaning scoreboard. Give Kent or Deanna a call at Johnson Sewer Cleaning, 715-732-0427 for all of your sewer and drain cleaning needs. Well, Thor Fluke will tee the ball up at the 40. And we'll wait to the kickoff. And he will get a foot into it. Long end over and kick on the run. It's fielded at the 15-yard line. Picked up over there by Matt Winter. Winter looking for some blocking. He's hit hard. Down on the far side, gang tackled by a bunch of Maroons right in front of their student section. And brought down at about the 25-yard line on the far side of the field. So first and 10, Red Robins here in the third quarter. And they're actually going to spot it at the 24-yard line, not the 25. And the Red Robins will break huddle. Wide receiver wide to the right side, and Max Nowinski is out there. Nagel hands it off up the middle, hit and brought down immediately. Immediate gain of one. He might give him 2 yards, but he was brought down as soon as he got to that line of scrimmage. That's their fullback, Will Dixon. Dixon picking up two. So Will Dixon, 7 carries for 13 yards for the Red Robins. And it'll be a second down and 8 now for Antigo from their own 26-yard line on the left hash. 2:39 to go, third quarter. A wing on the right, a wing on the left, split backs in the backfield again behind Alex Nagel. Nagel under center. Hill, quick spin, handoff, double handoff again. To the left will be Caleb Hunter trying to get around the edge. And the Maroons are all over that one to snuff it out. Hunter might have got a gain of a yard or two, but really not much. That play takes a lot of time to develop as they hand it off to Nowinski, and Nowinski hands it off to Hunter. By the time Hunter gets the ball, he's already about 3 to 4 yards behind the line of scrimmage. And the Maroons snuff that one out after he only gained a yard. So a one-yard gain for Caleb Hunter. He's got 3 carries for 2 yards tonight. I think all of his carries on that double reverse. Third down and seven, from the 27-yard line. In anti-go territory, the Red Robins have it. Nagel bootlegging to the right side. Matthias trying to apply some pressure now. Force out of the pocket. Nagel zips it, has the man. It's off, but it's incomplete. Good defensive coverage that time for the Menominee Maroons with Drew Baxter, as he was with Max Nowinski, and he popped that one away as soon as it got close to Nowinski, and the pass will fall incomplete and force a fourth down for the Antigo Red Robins. So a fourth down and seven from their 27-yard line, and Ethan Molesky will drop back to return this one for Menominee. The quarterback, Alex Nagel, is the punter again, so he will step back to punt this one. Molesky back at his own 40-yard line. Slight breeze, but nothing too bad here. Flag's not moving. Line drive kick. This bounces. Molesky will pick it up at the 44-yard line. Look for some blocking. Molesky cuts up across midfield, then he's hammered down at the 47. Tough play that time for Ethan Molesky as that ball was on the grass when he caught it. And he picked it up and he'll bring it into Antigo territory. Some nice little return for the Maroon sophomore. And they'll spot it right at the 47. So really a 20-yard punt after the return. First down and 10 Menominee to the Red Robin 47. Again, Menominee following up a 40-yard touchdown run by Nathan Noack. Let's see if they can keep things rolling here. With a minute 39 to go in this third quarter, they lead this one by 7. The Maroons on top, 28-21. Hunter Hass, wing to the left. Another wing to the right side. Geezy and Noack into the backfield for Menominee. Hunter Hass in motion from left to right. The snap the other way will be to Nathan Noack. Noack cuts up center of the field. Nathan Noack to the 40. Noack to the 35 to the 30. Nathan Noack to the 20. Noack to the 10. 5. Touchdown, Menominee. Back-to-back 40-plus yard runs for Nathan Noack. This one's for 47 yards, and the Maroons just put 6 more on the board. All Nathan Noack that time, using his speed and bouncing to the outside. You could just hear the breath come out of the Red Robin fans and the players after that run, with Menominee now on top 34-21 with a buck and a half remaining here in this third quarter. As we await Thor Fluke to attack on the extra point, the kick is high, the kick is up, and the kick is good. 35-21 at Menominee. Back after this on your Bay City's radio dial.
Glenn Zack, your local Tempstar dealer. Experts in heating, cooling, and sheet metal. Fully insured in Michigan and Wisconsin for your residential, commercial, and light industrial needs. Serving all brands, installation in new construction and remodels, along with preventative furnace and air conditioner maintenance. 24-hour emergency service available. Check out their website to see a full list of services offered at MenzaAndZack.com. Located at 60 Water Street in Marinette.
Well, Nathan Noack, his last 2 carries, 87 yards, and 2 touchdowns for the Menominee Maroons. As with a minute 30 to go in this third quarter, Menominee on top now, 35-21, according to that Johnson Sewer Cleaning scoreboard. Thor Fluke's extra point again being good, with a 47-yard TD run again for Noack. Nathan Noack, 15 carries, 212 yards, and 3 touchdowns. Fluke has the ball teed up at the 40. High, short, end-over-end kick. Fielded at the 26-yard line. That's Matt Winter. Winter cuts up now, trying to bounce the other side to the 35. Then he's hit and driven backwards at the 36-yard line. Jacob Stebbins leading the way for the Menominee Maroons. So a minute 23 to go in this third quarter. The Red Robin offense back on the attack. Very dangerous Red Robin team. Anything can happen right now. The Maroon defense need to stay strong and stay positive on the far side. So from their own 36-yard line, the Red Robins will start. As their last two possessions ended in punts. Now from their own 36. Only on the last look backs in the backfield coming up. Again, behind Nagel. Nagel bootlegging to the right, looking to pass. He'll float it right side, and the ball's tipped and intercepted by Nowak at the 45. Nathan Nowak to the 40. Nowak cuts up to the 35, and he's hit and hammered down to the 32-yard line. The screen pass was tipped by the intended receiver.
Nagel pass.
Looking for Will Dixon, couldn't seem to get it. And then it goes right into the hands of Nathan Nowak. We have an injured maroon down below, a little shaken up on the play. But Nathan Nowak now an interception for the Maroons. With a minute 11 to go in this third quarter. As the ball is placed all the way on the 31-yard line. In Antigo territory. So the first turnover of the game is an interception coming from Alex Nagel. The injured maroon is going to walk off underneath his own power. So the Menominee Maroon offense will head right back out onto the field with a minute 11 to go in this third again. At the Antigo 31-yard line, as the Maroons lead it by 14, 35 to 21. Gas keep a Razor in it, tailback. He will break huddle. Razor and Geezy into the backfield. Sam Larson wide to the right, or slot right. Ethan Molesky slot left. Another receiver wide to the left, another one wide to the right side. Razor, a couple of hard counts. He wants to run up the middle off right tackle. Keeper Razor now bounces to the other side. Razor to the 20. Flags fly, and he's brought down. Another flag flies to the 20-yard line. All in the vicinity of holding. We'll have to wait and see what that call is on the far side. Looks like an 11-yard pickup for Keeper Razor. But it'll possibly be wiped out by the Hankies, and they will be, looks like, holding penalties. And they will, the Red Robins will take the penalties. Two flags, same penalty. And as Nathan Nowak and Peyton Molesky come right back out of the field. They'll rotate some players. So a 10-yard penalty. Let's go back to the 39-yard line from the spot of the foul.
10-yard penalty makes it first and 20 for the Maroons.
So first down and 20 now for Menominee. Actually, first down and 19, I'm sorry, the 29. Two receivers left, two to the right. Nowak in, Geezy into the backfield for Menominee. Geezy goes in motion out of the backfield. Quick pass over to Zach Geezy. Geezy to the 40. Geezy cuts it to the 35 to the 30. Zach Geezy makes a man miss. Now he'll cut it up and he brought down shy of the 20-yard line. As Geezy goes in motion, then Nowak screens it out to him. With 38 seconds, he stays inbound, so it's ticking away here in this third quarter. So a nice quick pass play from Nathan Nowak to Zach Geezy.
There's a second and about one.
Looks like they spotted at the 22-yard line in the 17-yard gain. So Zach Geezy gets his first catch today. And then Maroons will break huddle. Two receivers left, two to the right side. Nowak and Geezy into the backfield again. Second down and one. Geezy up the middle. Geezy goes airborne. He's upended. Fighting extra effort to the 20-yard line. Should be enough for the first down. As you wait, the official call is the clock. They're going to stop the clock right now to place the ball. And then they'll start the clock once they get it down. This will more than likely be the end of the first quarter, as it is going to be a first down with a 2-yard gain for Zach Geezy.
Geezy on the carry. Picks up the first down.
So first down for the Maroons.
And
they're going to let the clock tick down. This will end the third quarter. A very good third quarter for Menominee. They score two touchdowns, and they get a turnover. At the end of three, that Johnson Sewer Cleaning scoreboard reads Menominee 35, Antigo 21.
Go west on 180 at the holiday. Save on cars and trucks every day. Your start to save above the when you take that drive. West on 180 to the riverside. You get to the roundabout, make sure you yield. Don't go straight, cause it's all cornfields. Just turn left when you see that sign. Come on in to Riverside. We'll find what you're looking for. Just show up at our front door. Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram trucks. No overhead seats, you big bucks. Come take a ride if you dare. Out with cows in the country air. Save big money on your next ride when you see your friends at Riverside. From the West Big 64 until you get
opera door in Marinette. You're sure to feel the bummer when you take that drive. One way or another gets you Riverside. One way or another gets you Riverside.
Hey, I'm back at it right here on your hometown radio station, 103.7 FM. I'm Josh Kellner, here with you again. Glad you could join me on your Bay Cities radio dial. First down and 10 for the Menominee Maroons in Antigo territory as they spot this one at the 20-yard line. Everybody in tight for Menominee. Nowak and Yeezy into the backfield. Nowak up the middle. Nowak cuts to the outside now, and a flag will fly as he slips his way to the 15-yard line as we'll wait and see who this hanky is.
Flag on the play, preliminary signal holding.
So the clock will stop, and it looks like it's going to be another holding penalty on Menominee. Their second holding penalty this half. And they'll march this one back. They'll bring up a first down and a 20 now for the Maroons. Ooh, this one's way back. The spot of the foul. This is like almost like a 15-yard penalty. All the way back to the... Oh, that's right. All the way back to the 30-yard line.
First down and 20 for the Maroons.
So first down and 20 now for Menominee. Back to the 30. Sam Larson, wing to the right. Molesky, a wing to the left. He's in motion from left to right. Geezy wants to run wide. Zach Geezy cuts it up now, trying to bounce to the outside. He's hitting up ended at about the 27-yard line. So it'll be second down and a 17 now.
Geezy taken down by Wickersheim.
Depending on the spot that they gave him, it was going to be a three-yard pickup for Zach Geezy. So second down and 17. 11:08 remaining in this game. 35-21 Menominee. And with the second and 17 at the Antigo 27-yard line. Everybody in tight. Nowak will hand it off. It's going to be a pass play to Molesky's. Looking to pass now. He's going to tuck and try to run to the 25-yard line. Lowers his shoulder. He'll take it to about the 23. Possibly, let's see if they give him a 23-yard line.
Molesky on the carry, taken down by
Ethan Thunder. Molesky getting his
for the Robins.
Second call of the game.
14.
Picking up 4 yards, trying to sweep around the left side. Yeah, his first carry of the game. His second one, he didn't really get a chance to carry it, as it he bobbled it and fumbled it in the first series of the game for the Maroons. And now they'll break huddle. Third down and 13 for Menominee. All the way to the Antigo 22-yard line. Two receivers left, two to the right side. Nowak and Geezy into the backfield. Geezy in motion out of the backfield. Quick pass over to Zach Geezy, and he overled him, and it'll fall incomplete. Same play as before. This one falls incomplete now for the Maroons.
But
they got a nice first down on earlier. And the Maroons will now have a fourth down. Fourth down and 13 at the Antigo 22-yard line. Again, Menominee on top, 35-21, 9:57 remaining in this contest. Peyton Lesky runs a play in for the Maroons. And they will break huddle. All UP center, Andrew Linnan takes the team up to the ball. Peyton Lesky wide to left, Ethan Lesky slot left. Sam Larson wide to the right, actually slot right Larson, Hunter Hass wide to the right. Ethan Molesky motion from left to right. Nowak and Geezy in the backfield. Nathan Nowak looks right, and he slips and falls down. He went to cut to the left, to pass the left side, and he slipped and lost his footing and fell to the ground. That'll be a turnover on downs for the Maroons at the 27-yard line.
Nowak.
So a 5-yard loss slips on that.
First. That'll
as he slips and falls down.
A turnover on downs. First down, Robin.
As the Maroons were over the 400-yard mark offensively, now they're back under that, 396 yards so far in the game for Menominee. And the Antigo Red Robins will get it back on their own 27. Nagel, under center, hands, big hole, off left tackle, hit, breaking through, slipping it, falling down. Nothing but green grass that time was in front of Caleb Hunter. Then he slipped and fell down. We have an injured Maroon down below. As Alex Nagel takes the ball to the 37-yard line on a 10-yard pickup to move the chains.
taken down by Molesky.
So a 10-yard gain for Nagel, and Molesky is credited with the tackle.
First down.
The Red Robin first down. Ninja Maroon is sitting up right now, trying to catch his breath, and he'll walk across. With 9:50 remaining in this contest, the Maroons are on top by 14, 35-21. The Red Robin's going to try to get a drive rolling here, down by two touchdowns. Andrew Maroon walking off underneath his own power. He'll be back in a few moments. So Alex Nagel breaks huddle. He'll have his team up to the ball. Best trainer in the business, Derek Butler out there. He made the trip here today. That's one man that you want on your team. Big deal for Menominee Maroon Athletics having someone like Derek Butler. And now we're ready to go. Into the ballgame for the injured Maroon, Adam Beiersdorf. Actually, Beiersdorf has been playing a lot, but just must have had a break. Came back in. Still one receiver wide to the left. Slot left as well. And the slot is Wickersham. Wing in motion from right to left. They're going to hand it off to him. That's Caleb Hunter. Hunter, the ball popped out. Picked up by Molesky. Molesky to the 30. Ethan Molesky makes it cut to the 20. Molesky to the 15. Brought down to the 10. Football ball, but it goes out of bounds. As he bobbled it, crossing, trying to stretch it extra yardage, but he's brought down to the 5-yard line. The ball popped out of Caleb Hunter's hands. Molesky picked it up off the grass. Then a touchdown-saving track tackle by Alex Nagel, but a big turnover there. So Ethan Molesky
10-yard line
gets a fumble here in the fourth with 9:40 to go. Giving the Maroons first and goal. They're going to mark it at the 10-yard line. I'm sorry, not the 5. And the Maroons are missing a player. Keeper Racer comes running in at the last second and gives a play. Actually, he had the play. Noah gave him what the play was and what the count was. Up the middle, Zach Giese. Giese spinning his way forward. Now he'll cut it back to the 5 and pushing his way, trying to get some extra yardage, but I think he'll just get to the 5. If that's what they're going to give it to him.
Giese on the carry, taken down by.
Let's see, it is going to be Giese to the second down to the 5 on that far side of the field. Getting hard to see things down there. We'll give Giese a 5-yard gain. So the 5-yard pickup. For Zach Giese, puts the Maroons over 400 yards again. And the Maroons lift the brick huddle. Larson a wing to the right, Molesky a wing to the left. Nowak and Giese. Giese has a call. Zach Giese pushing his way forward up the middle. Keeps his feet going up and touchdown, Menominee! 5-yard touchdown run, Zach Giese. He gets his second touchdown of the game. And the Maroons put 6 more on the board. Here at the 8:48 mark.
Fluke on to attempt the extra point.
As we'll wait for Fluke to tack on the extra point. Snap, kick. Kick is up, and the kick is good. Menominee 42. Antigo 21. 8:48 to go. Back after this in your Bay City is a radio dial.
Antigo 21.
Renza and Zach, your local Tempstar dealer. Experts in heating, cooling, and sheet metal. Fully insured in Michigan and Wisconsin. For your residential, commercial, and light industrial needs. Serving all brands, installation in new construction and remodels. Along with preventative furnace and air conditioner maintenance. 24-hour emergency service available. Check out their website to see a full list of services offered at MenzaandZach.com. Located at 60 Water Street in Marinette.
And back yet, right here in your hometown radio station, 103.7 FM, WHYB, Menominee and Marinette, and BayCitiesOnline.com. Josh Kellner along with you again. I'd like to thank Ekmer Heating and Sheet Metal at 1212 18th Avenue in Menominee. They probably support the Menominee Maroons. Well, Ethan Molesky fumble return to the 10-yard line. 2 plays later, set up a 5-yard touchdown run by Zach Giese. Thor Fluke's extra point being good. Menominee on top 42-21, according to that Johnson Sewer Cleaning scoreboard. 8:48 remaining in this game. Short end-over-end kickoff coming from Fluke, and trying to return it, Cody below, and he takes the ball across the 35 to about the 33-yard line for Cody. And it'll be a first down and 10 again for the Red Robins, now down by three scores. The Red Robins scoreless here in the second half. Menominee pouring on 22 second half points. As Antigo was on top at halftime, 21-20. So first down and 10 now for the Red Robins. And they'll spot the ball, like I said, on their own 37-yard line. One receiver to the left. Slip back to the backfield behind Nagel. Nagel spins, hands off, trying to bounce the outside. Now cutting his way in was Max Nowinski. Nowinski goes off right tackle. And he'll pick up about 5 yards. So a 5 yard gain for Nowinski.
Gary picks up almost five, second and five.
So it'll be a second down and a five on the way now for these Red Robins. I've been saying Max Nowinski's name a lot. He's had 9 carries for just 18 yards, though, as the Maroons have held him in check. Alex Nagel, have a good game. 93 yards rushing and 2 touchdowns. Second down and five on the 43-yard line. Nagel wants to run to the left side. He'll cut up. Zach Easy nearly had him. Now coming up and bringing him down back to the 41-yard line. Hauling him down is Sam Larson for the Maroons. Nagel, this will be a loss of a few, depending on the spot that they're going to give him. A loss of two.
Third down and seven.
Good job that time for Sam Larson of Menominee. So a 2 yard loss that time for Nagel. I was just talking about him. He's now down to 91 yards. 7:32 remaining in this game. Again, 42-21 Maroons. The Red Robins undefeated coming into this one with wins over Two Rivers and shutting out Oconto last week. Three backs in the backfield behind Nagel. Now sent up as a wing to the right will be Elijah Wickersheim. From their own 41 on the left hash, Nagel will spin. He'll hand off up the middle. Big hole pushing his way forward. Reisner will come up and bring him down. Reisner along with Hunter Haas to bring down their big fullback, you know, Will Dixon. So Dixon brings the ball into Menominee territory to the 47-yard line.
Taken down by Haas.
So a 9-yard run that time. Sorry, it was a 12-yard run at time for Dixon. Well, Dixon, 25 yards now today. Waiting to the right, three backs in the backfield. Spin, handing off again. It's Dixon up the middle. Dixon to the 40-yard line. And Hunter Haas and Kiefer Reisner there to bring down Dixon at the 31-yard line. So back-to-back runs. Or 36-yard line for Will Dixon. That one for a 13-yard gain.
Haas on the tackle.
So Hunter Haas again on the tackle on that 13-yard gain. First down and 10 with 6:40 remaining in this game for the Red Robins. At the Menominee 36-yard line. Wide to the right side, Luke Berner, three backs in the backfield again behind Alex Nagel. Nagel under center. He'll spin, fake the handoff, now hand it off to the right side, trying to bounce to the right. It's going to be Max Nowinski. Nowinski gets a few positive yards as he gets to the 35, Nowinski, maybe the 34. And he'll gain just a yard. It'll be a second down and 9. And they'll place the ball right on the, right across the 35. So we'll say it's a 34 for a gain of 2. So a 2 yard pickup for Nowinski. Second down and 8 at the Menominee 34-yard line. Off to the right on the wing is Wickersheim. Three backs in backfield. Check that split backs in backfield. Nagel spins. Hands off a big hole again up the middle for Will Dixon. And Dixon shy of that first down marker, crossing the Menominee 30 to the 29-yard line. Picking up 5. So a 5 yard pickup. They're getting some chunks of yardage here. The clock continues to tick. 5.5 minutes remaining. Third down and a long 3. On the Menominee 29-yard line. On the left side, Nowinski has a wing. Split backs again behind Nagel. Nagel spins, fakes the handoff, bootlegging to the right side, looking to pass. He'll float it right side. Has a man out there. Diving catch. No, he couldn't hold on. Good effort on the far side by that young man. Just couldn't seem to pull it in.
Intended for.
Looks like it was intended for Matt Winter on the far side. Ethan Molesky in coverage. That pass will fall incomplete. Alex Nagel's last 6 passes have not reached his intended target. One of them was caught, but that was by Nathan Noah for an interception. Otherwise, all 6 men incomplete. And that pass will stop the clock with 5:16 remaining in this game. Fourth down and a long three of the Menominee 29-yard line for the Red Robins. On the left hash, wing on the left, spinning, handing off again. Big hole at the middle, the first down at the 32-yard line. Finally brought down was Will Dixon. So a nice little run that time for Dixon, as he brings the ball to both the 22-yard line for a 7-yard pickup. Hunter Haas in the tackle for the Maroons. So 11 carries for 50 yards for Will Dixon of the Antigo Red Robins. First down and 10, the ball's on the Maroon at 22-yard line. Under 5 minutes remaining in this game. Split backs in the backfield, coming up behind Nagel. Nagel spins, gives it to Dixon again. Dixon trying to find a seam. He does. Now he'll try to bounce to the outside, but he's brought down by three Maroons. Hunter Haas.